Game three promised to be a battle of wills, with both teams not at one game apiece. The action moved to Singapore. Xavier Alexander, a little spin move there. Josh Boone, he did that a lot, getting behind the defense. Desperate times in the Lion City. The Singapore trying to keep pace. Good job by X-Man staying in the air. Coach Torres giving orders to his troop, but it was Hong Kong with a four-point lead at the end of the day. And welcome once again to ABL Basketball, the 2016-17 Finals between the top seed league champion Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, the second seed hometown Singapore Slingers, right here at the OCBC Arena. Some of the fans getting ready to come into the arena here. Go Slingers. Yes, I think most Singapore Slingers fans that are watching either here or at home would agree, and there's what they're playing for, the ABL Cup, the Championship Cup. And just in case Hong Kong is able to wrap up proceedings here, they do lead the series 2-1 in the best of five. It is on display for the fans to oogle at right now. Of course, the Slingers would rather that cup be moved over to Hong Kong. That would mean that they are in it for a Game 5 confirmation for our game today. Singapore Slingers versus Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. Game 4, with Game 3 going to Hong Kong just a couple of nights ago on Friday. There is that big man there, Justin Howard. Well, didn't have a whole lot to do with him. He scored 31 points and grabbed 23 boards. There is Coach Torres. He has steadily helped his troops get to the top of the pile right now, to the point where they just are one game away from that championship in their maiden season. What an amazing feat that would be for these Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. And speaking of them, we will introduce them right now. First, the guys off the bench, and what a productive bench it has been for Hong Kong throughout this series. Anyway, there is Josh Boone right there. He's taking his licks. He had a little bit of an injury a little while ago, but recovered in time for game three. He had some crucial points, 18 points and 13 rebounds for Hong Kong in that four-point win. It has been a team effort, and everybody on board, especially the local guys who have really come to play, Chan Sui Wee and Fong Xin Yi in particular, have been crucial down the stretch of a couple of these games for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. There are the Singapore Slingers right there, led by the big man Justin Howard, the 35-year-old, the ageless wonder, again scoring 45 points in that game one win, 92-76. Wong Wei Long, he has been the MVP local player the last couple of years. You wonder if he will get the nod again for year number three. We'll find out in a little bit. There is Leon Kwek, the future perhaps of Singapore local basketball, having himself a heck of a season, averaging over 12 points a game. And some of the other players for Singapore, that's Leon Deng, 30-year-old. Ung Han Bin has been instrumental in a couple of Singapore's wins. He's a very streaky shooter, hasn't really gotten a lot of minutes in the finals. And there is Mitchell Folkoff. He won't be playing today. Has a little bit of an MCL issue. Perhaps if we get a chance to go to Hong Kong, he will be back in the fray. Desmond Oh, defensive specialist, but he can get you a bucket when you need one. He had one the other day on the reverse. You saw that at the leadoff of the show in there for his defense. Josh Erspin Tondo, up and down playoffs for him. He had 23 in the first game, disappointing last game, including a turnover, a crucial turnover at the wrong time. But it's a new day now. Xavier Alexander, one of the heart and souls of this Singapore team, averaging 19 points a game. Had 13 rebounds for Singapore, a goal with 23 points in the last game. Probably the most improved local player on the Singapore team, Galvin Goh, the 22-year-old 6'7 center. And there he is, Justin Howard, obviously in the most valuable player conversation. We'll find out if he has done enough this season to warrant that. But defensively and offensively on both sides of the ball, he has been a marvel to behold the entire season. And they will be depending on him greatly to get this game in hand. If they were to tie it up at 2-2 to go to Hong Kong, that game would be played on Tuesday in Hong Kong. This will be our last game transmission here from Singapore. Chuck Schreiner along with Michael Wong. And Michael, the electricity in the air, both these teams, is do or die for Singapore and Coach Ngo.
It's very good. Matchup right now, because after the last game, you know, both teams are really very, very familiar with each other. You know, I expect this game to be high intensity. You know, both teams are going to go hard at each other, because for the Singapore Singers, it's a do it all. You know, it's either this game or and they're done. They got to fight for a surviving chance to go back to Hong Kong.
So we're just about ready to get ready for some awards. Five awards going to be on display here. They're going to be presented by Jeremy Elagan, the CEO of the ABL. Justin Howard would definitely be in the race for one of those, I would think.
You begin by welcoming the Chief Operating Officer.
So here is Jericho Elagan.
Please all give a warm welcome to Mr. Jericho Elagan.
Again, the Chief Operating Officer of the Asian Basketball League, and he's got to be real proud, Michael, of the status of this league now. It's an up-and-coming league, and I tell you what, the talent just keeps getting better and better every year.
Yeah, I think the league has generated a lot of interest locally. So I think it's going to expand in the next few years. Probably we'll be inviting teams from Korea, Japan, hopefully. You know, China seems interested. So I think the whole league will take the whole local scene by storm. Yeah, as this league grows, it probably won't be called ASEAN Basketball League anymore. It could be called Asia Basketball League eventually.
So the first award goes to Coach of the Year in a kind of a no-brainer with this. Edward Torres of the Hong Kong Eastern Line guiding his team to a 16-4 record and all the way to the finals, and in fact one game away from lifting the championship. Congratulations, Coach. A very basketball-savvy man. Don't want to say young man. He's been around for a few years, obviously, but what a job he's done with the talent that he has been given. He does have a lot of talent, but I tell you what, it takes somebody to take that talent and to mold it into a winning team. You can't just have individuals. You do have to get them into shape so that they can play as a team.
Through the elimination round, he averaged 19 points, 7.6
Most valuable player for locals being awarded now.
In each of those categories, he led all locals in the league. In one game, in the elimination round, he also set a new record for most points scored by a local with 41 points. Give it up for your MVP in the local category from Ala Pilipinas, Bobby Ray Parks Jr.
Well, no surprise there, Bobby Ray Parks. His father, a great basketball player in the Philippines and the state, so 19 points a game, ninth overall. First among the locals, 7.6 rebounds a game. First among the locals with 4.2 assists a game. Fifth overall, and again, first amongst locals. Well-deserved award, most valuable player for the local players, Bobby Ray Parks. We'll be no doubt seeing a lot more of him if he doesn't go to the PBA.
He's definitely a do-it-all kind of player, you know. He contributes in every single aspect of the basketball game. It's a pity that actually, you know, his season ended with an injury.
Most valuable player, heritage import. Now that's a player that has roots in Asia. Might have, usually these guys have dual passports.
Your MVP among heritage imports from the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, Tyler Lamb.
Tyler Lamb, the most valuable player, heritage import. He has Filipino and American passport. Again, well-deserved, averaging 19 points a game, second among the heritage imports, 6.2 rebounds a game, also second, 3.6 assists per game, second among heritage imports, 2.6 steals per game, although second as far as the heritage imports go. So, very nice guy. I interviewed him right before the game. An alumni of UCLA, at one point he was touted as one of the top 5 point guards in the nation in the U.S. and has applied his basketball skills in Asia, Southeast Asia, and the Philippines. So congratulations to Tyler Lamb. Now, Defensive Player of the Year.
Ladies and gentlemen, our Defensive Player of the 7th season of the ABL averaged 18.1 rebounds per game. He led the league in that category. He also averaged 1.7 blocks per game and was second in that department. In game one of the ABL Finals, he set a new record of grabbing 28 rebounds and the finals from your Singapore Slingers, Justin Howard.
Justin Howard, Defensive Player of the Year, and they forgot one category, Michael Wong. He led the league in scoring. So led the league in scoring, first in rebounds, second overall in blocks per game, defensive player of the year, Justin Howard. And don't see him anywhere. Well, there he is, getting ready to come on now. Obviously, his mind's 1,000 miles away trying to get ready for the game, but well-deserved award for Justin. Some people thought that he probably should have gotten the Most Valuable Player award, but great honor for him and Justin. What a job he's done the last 2 years for the Singapore Slingers, and you wonder if he's going to be back for year number three. Conflicting stories on that, but very, very well deserved award for Justin Howard.
This guy averaged 24.9 points per game and was second overall in the entire league. He also grabbed 6.9 rebounds, averaged 6.2 assists, and was also second in that category.
Now the Most Valuable Player of World Report.
That he is the complete package, also averaged 1.3 steals per game. The Most Valuable World Import of the seventh season of the ABL, from the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, Marcus Elliott.
Marcus Elliott, well-deserved award for him. Flip a coin, either him or Justin Howard. Marcus Elliott, of course, he did play on the team with the best record, 16-4 Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, and big award for Mr. Elliott, 24.9 points a game, second in the league overall. Wow. So pretty good distribution, Michael, of awards. Coach of the Year going to Hong Kong. Local Most Valuable Player going to Las Filipinas. Most Valuable Player Heritage Import, again, going to Hong Kong. A Singapore Slinger in there, and also Marcus Elliott. So these guys will be doing battle with each other, those three right there, in just a few minutes, but a time for them to be friends and comrades in arms as they push the ABL to new limits. And the award, again, given by Jericho Elagun, the COO of the ABL. And all these guys, very, very worthy recipients of these awards. Bobby Ray Parks of Las Filipinas there in his street clothes. Of course, Las Filipinas eliminated by the Singapore Slingers in two straight in the first round. And that will do it. So we will get ready for the game now since the festivities have finished. Now for the starting lineups for both these teams. Marcus Elliott, Lee Key, Josh Boone, Tyler Lamb, Fong Shi Xingyi of the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. On the other side of the ball, Desmond O, Josh Erzben Tondo, Xavier Alexander, Delvin Goh, and Justin Howard. So Singapore will try to erase the stench of those unsightly turnovers in game one and two, or two and three, 25 and 22. Well, before the game, we talked to some coaches and players about their respective attitudes about what to look forward to in game four.
We try to limit the turnover to a single digit, and of course we need to really come out, protect the ball, because they come on us aggressively on defense, so we need to really need to take care of the ball.
Well, like we said in our film session yesterday, if everybody makes one less mistake, then we win that game. We win game two, so we're looking forward to doing that. Looking forward to get out here and playing hard and taking care of business today.
They're going to come out with a lot of intensity, and what we have to do is we have to have a step up to their intensity, you know what I mean? We have to not only match their intensity, but take it to another level. And I think in a game like this, we set the tone early, and I think we'll be okay.
We're a team. We play like a team. We lost as a team, and we won as a team. And we're here once again to be a team, and that includes all the players in the roster.
Well, throw everything in, do or die. You know, we are down, but we are not out yet. So we are not going to let them celebrate in our home court. So we won't need to take this win and go back to Hong Kong, and hopefully their pressure back at their home court.
Okay, well, here are the stats so far as scores go for games one through three. Game one, to everybody's surprise, Singapore coming and blowing Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions off their own courts, 92-76. That was a game where Justin Howard had 45 points and 28 rebounds. Game two, an emotional game. Fans and referees and everybody getting involved, it seemed like. Hong Kong standing above it all at the end, walking away with a 92-84 victory. And then they coming back to Singapore on Friday night, a game that could have gone either way, a mistake here, a mistake there. Singapore's perspective, they come up short 76-72. So that brings us to game four, where we are today, Michael Wong. And what does Singapore have to do? There's a must win for them or else they go home. What's it going to take for them to get out of here with a W?
Well, there are two things that's glaring right now from the last game. So first would be their turnovers. You know, they really got to limit their turnovers to less than 20. You know, the last few games they lost, they had 25 and maybe 23. And this is unheard of. And their turnovers actually come at very crucial periods of the game. So it's actually turning points where the momentum actually shifts or they actually lose their points and lose the lead due to turnover. So they got to take the pressure, defensive pressure from the Hong Kong Long Lions, and handle it a little bit better. You know, they got to attack it, they got to be aggressive with it, they got to be strong with the ball. The next thing would be definitely, you know, support from the players. You can't expect the world import to be carrying the team for the whole 40 minutes. The last game, there was no support from anywhere else. No one was doing anything. They were not creating, they were not hitting shots. You know, everyone needs to contribute. This is a Singapore team that's based on depth of the bench and the local players. So they got to find their identity. They got to find their defensive effort together. And then, you know, offensively, they got to find a way to get everyone involved.
Punctuated by that 2 of 15 miserable shooting percentage from beyond the arc, something that Singapore did very, very well in game one. If you go back less than a week ago, or a little bit over a week ago, 9 days ago to be exact, Singapore shot the lights off. They distributed the ball very well. They kicked the ball out when they needed to and allowed hitting their outside shots, allowed Howard and Alexander to do what they do so well on the inside, dribble penetration and around the low block. But without that, Hong Kong just collapses the zone and makes life very, very difficult. So we'll see if they come out the same way. What do we have here? Re-jump. Tyler Lamb coming away with the ball, but double tap you can see there by Justin Howard. So they'll bring it back and line it up again. Here we are, game four. Will it be the last game of the ABL season? Chuck Schreiner and Michael Wong, so happy you could hang out with us today. Elliott on the left side, Alexander tailing him. Just shooting, Tyler Lamb. Put the ball on the floor and immediately picked up by Singapore. Now still on the floor, kick it out again, and boom, picks it up. Inside, picked off by Alexander. Good anticipation for him, stepping in the lane. First turnover of the game, or has been Tondo. Head fake, double head fake. There's a screen, back out again, it will come. Elliott on him, forcing it back. Go, still go, all the way to the basket, misses a layup. Wow. So a couple of errors right away, knocked away by Howard. Justin beseeching his team up. We saw last game, Josh, getting behind the defense a couple of times. That almost occurred again. You see Justin Howard having words with Go real quick. We can't let that happen like we saw last game. Fong rotating the ball. Out to Chan, who had a good game last game, 8 points. Elliott again, acceleration. Tough angle. Fong gets it and tips it over to number 10. That is Tyler Lamb. Wide open look for Elliott. Yes, from Treesville. Good ball rotation again by Hong Kong, and they get first blood here in the game. Comes at the 8:45 mark. Alexander. Lamb will pick him up. Erzman Tano again, that head fake again. Flashing across the middle is both Howard and Go. Double screen there. Alexander being freed up. He'll shoot that ball and hit it. Around the free throw area, 3-2. So Alexander right off the bat, getting Singapore on the board. Josh kicks back outside to Lamb. Rotation over to Chan. Off the screen is Elliott. Good acceleration. A little fallback jumper there off the glass and in. So Elliott owns all 5 points to begin with. Hong Kong with a little nifty 5-2 lead to begin the proceedings here at the 8-minute mark here in the first quarter at the OCBC Arena in Singapore, game four. Singapore wins. They take it back to Hong Kong. Desmond Oh. There's a foul there. Let's see who that goes against. Is it an offensive foul? We will see. So that will be on the Long Lions. So let's watch it again. There's Fong with the push right there, the little bump. Go, double pump fake off the glass. Well, that's where he's so effective on that left side. His footwork is much improved. And again, trying to get it underneath the defense again. Shot from Freesville off the mark. Howard there to clean it up. So quick release by Chan, no good. Go. Again, turns, nowhere to go there. And he comes it back out to Alexander, who splits the lane. Right side shot, Desmond open, Freesville, and it sticks up between the cylinder and the glass. So that will be a turn, not turnover, a one and out for Singapore. They've climbed to within one. Last game was a very low scoring affair by especially Hong Kong standard. They led the league with 91 points average, and they only put 76, but to their release, Singapore only 72. That ball skittles out of bounds over the top. So Hong Kong will get the ball. I mistakenly said that the ball was trapped in between the rim and the glass. It would be Hong Kong's ball. It was not. Back comes Elliott. Left-hand dribble. Again, being trailed by Alexander. Fong lurking around that low post. Chen. Inside the lamp. Lamp knocked away by Go. Save. Fong. Yes. Singapore guilty of ball watching a little bit there. That's a two, so 7-4. Hong Kong almost picked off. Alexander. There's been Tondo. Howard now down low. Boone on him. Nice little footwork there. Off the mark. Offensive board taken by Irisman Tondo. He'll back it up a little bit. Tyler Lamb looking for Alexander. He'll have to back it up and in the hands of long three. That's going to be well short. A little bit out of Justin's sights, I think. Very quickly bringing it down. 5-on-4 and a foul by Irisman Tondo. That might have been a clever foul there because Justin Howard was down at the other end. That will be on Josh Irisman Tondo, so one on him. Hong Kong looking a little bit more patient in this game. It was a very frenetic pace last game defensively we saw by both these teams. So Lamp to take it out on the near sidelines here. Elliott, who had 21 last game, bounce pass into Fong. Fong looking for space. Rises, fires, and got it. So 9-4. Over to the top of Delvin Goh. Irisman Tondo slips it over to Alexander. Flashing across is Goh. Inside. Foul. Let's see who that goes against. It's going to be on Justin Howard. So it'll be one on the big man. 9-4 lead by Hong Kong. They've got a couple of offensive boards. Watch it again. And there is Howard stepping in the space of Josh Boone. Elliott again being picked up by Alexander. Now the switch. Desmond O on Chan. Elliott, he'll take that long three. It'll be off the mark that time. Howard pulls it down the rebound. Irisman Tondo now switching to the left hand. Gets around two defenders. Nothing there on the inside. Go. Left hand. Want to watch himself. He had his pocket picked a couple times. Inside it goes and a foul there. Good pass by Delvin Goh that time, Michael, to find Desmond O. The foul will be on number 10, Tyler Lamb. That will be one on him. Second team foul. So Lamb with one. Fong with one. Desmond O around one screen. Gets the ball inside and is fouled again. Let's see who that goes on. That will be on, believe, Chan. So dribble penetration. Nice job by Desmond O. There it is, the hand from behind. So Wong Wei Long checking in to the delight of this packed OCBC arena. We'll take Desmond O's place. Wong carrying the ball and losing the ball inside, but I believe last touch by Fong. So Singapore will have it out on their baseline. Hong Kong, Michael, excellent on defense. We've seen them the last three games now just really step it up on the defensive end.
Even though so, I think what we're seeing for the last three possessions has been really encouraging. You know, the local boys are actually trying to create something.
Oh boy, in and out. Cleaning it up is Howard. Howard gets his own rebound. Clearing out. Got it in one. Fong with the foul. Great job by Howard, staying with it, missing on the layup. How did that ball not go in by Josh Erzmintano? There it is. Missing right there, and up he goes. We'll take your pick, either Elliott or Fong. Strong move to the basket by Howard.
I think they gave it to Elliott.
They did give it to Elliott, so one on him. Elliott got in a bit of foul trouble at the beginning of last game. Remember, he was ejected from game two. Big man converts, so that brings Singapore to within two. 9-7, they trail. Elliott barking signals. Quick pass downstairs to Chen. Chen again. Lamb, wide open look for Elliott. Elliott, left hand, acceleration, back outside again. Quick release by Chen is off the mark. So Singapore, chance to tie it up or go one up here on this possession. Delvin, left hand. Foul underneath. And that will go on number three, Lee Key, who's checked into the game. So four team fouls now on Hong Kong as they are guilty of holding on inside. So timeout for Hong Kong. Coach Torres, who has just been crowned the coach of the year, wants a word with his boys. And on the other side, Singapore has got to be feeling a little bit better, at least, Michael, than their last couple of possessions.
It seems like they are very deliberate in this game to try to get everyone else involved besides the William Pauls. You know, they've been running a few cuts, a backdoor cut by Desmond, good read by Delvin, passing him the ball, and Weilong going strong to the basket. And now with Josh trying to even post up. You know, it seems like they're more active this game than the rest of the players, and they're trying to make sure the same thing doesn't happen as in game three.
You made a very good point in the run-up to the game, Michael, saying that the local guys have to get involved. And by getting involved, we don't mean necessarily just lining up to shoot the ball from the outside. As you just said, they need to make some positive cuts, some backdoor plays, setting that up, running baselines, just making Hong Kong move their feet on the interior. Because last game, they didn't have to do that as much. They just collapsed the zone and waited for the action to come to them. So I think Singapore remains to be seen how successful they're going to be, but at least moving those feet on the inside and then catching them where they're a step behind and grabbing on and getting a couple of cheap fouls for Singapore here, at least in the early going. So I'm sure that is not lost on Coach Torres, as he will be making the adjustments to that interior defense for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lines. And there is Howard right there. He's got 3 points. Go with two. Alexander with two on that side of the ball. On the other side of the ball, it is Elliott who has a point, and Lee with a pair. We'll get you the first quarter statistics after the quarter is ended and flash them up to you. So, at the line, Josh Erzmintano gets the first one for a chance to tie it up. Joshua will be anxious to make up for, by his standards, at least a subpar performance last game. He was brilliant in game one, however, 23 points, 5 of 8 from downtown, so tied up at 9. Elliott, back to Elliott. Singapore looks like they're in a zone right now. Bomb left alone. Off the mark there, Erzmintano pulls down his second rebound. Gets it going the other end. Long three by Erzmintano. And stepping in to get the rebound is Howard. Don't know how smart of a shot that was. Quick in the game now. Wong. Still Wong in the lane. Back outside to Howard. Howard pull up jumper. Off the mark. Rebound for Erzmintano on the offensive end. So another offensive board. Trying to force the ball down inside to Howard, and last touch by Hong Kong. So it'll be Singapore on the baseline. 9 seconds left on the shot clock. 3:39 left here in the first quarter. It's a good one so far. Singapore obviously 2-1 down, upping the intensity. Turn and shoot by Erzmintano off the mark. Left foul. That'll go on Fong. Wow, Singapore very active on the offensive boards, Michael.
Yeah, everyone's getting into the act.
The miss by Josh. The quick follow by Quick. There it is right there, and the push. So that'll be two on Fong. Missing the first of two, so a chance to go up by two goes by the wayside. see just how much of that very emotional game three took out of both these teams. So Singapore with their first lead of the game, 10-9. It comes at the 3:34 mark. Chen Sui-Wee had 12 points last game. Tyler Lamb, Irvin Tondo late picking him up, gliding through the middle, left-hand layup. Sees party for him, so that lead short-lived and picked off at the other end by Lamb. Back the other way comes Elliott, the lead pass, but Boone for the clutch. Some temper starting to rise here. Boone did that repeatedly, Michael, in game three, able to get behind the defense. Does it again, so the bucket by Lamb, and the Singapore defense going to sleep after the steal, so a turn, a bucket, a turnover, and then a pitch behind the defense, and Quek losing the ball out of bounds, another turnover for Singapore, wow. So shades of what we saw, Michael, and this is exactly what Singapore cannot afford to do. 22 turnovers last game, 25 turnovers in game number two. Elliott running the offense now, the MVP, World Imports this season. Very smooth ball player. Off it goes, right into the path of Alexander. Lead pass to Wong. Other side, wide open look, rotated to Quek from Threesville, way off the mark, it's nothing. Lead pass again, but this time Alexander able to pick it off. Long three by Irvin Tondo! So that will tie it up at 13. Well, that's more like it. Josh, good by one last game. It's good to get that monkey off your back early as possible. So that time, fortuitous turnaround on the turnover. Down low to Boone. Boone will get that nice and smooth up in the air that time, getting the separation from Howard. Under 2 minutes to go here. 15-13, two-point lead. Irvin Tondo barking signals. He's got Wong to his right. Gets the ball to Alexander. Howard on the high post. Stepping in and balls on the floor. Alexander has it. Irvin Tondo for another triple. Well, making something out of nothing, Michael. Singapore living dangerously, but it paid off for him that time. Boone with the ball down low again. This time it's short with the baby hook. Irvin Tondo again, he's got the hot hand. Switches to the right hand, comes through. Wild shot by him, thrown up. A little bit out of control there by Josh. Tyler Lamb loses it momentarily, now gets it back. Picked off, saved. Elliott, Boone, yes. And one. So 17-16. A little bit of a sloppy game on both ends of the floor, Michael, at the moment. There it is, and Alexander can't get back in. Look at the mismatch. He's caught with Wong Wei Long. Nothing he can do, so he fouls him. Boone, who is not a good free throw shooter, to put it mildly, will be at the line to try and stretch the lead to two. Singapore briefly up on a couple of occasions, but shooting themselves in the foot down at the other end. Boone actually did fairly well. Howard does enough to hold on to it. So back comes Singapore. Wong Wei Long gets it across the line. Joshua's been Tondo to Howard. Looking for Alexander to make a cut. Back outside to Wong, who lines it up. The third triple by Singapore. They lead by two. Elliott behind the back takes the screen and fires away. Ties it up at 19 apiece. How smooth is Marcus Elliott? The MVP, Wong. Alexander now playing at the low post. They get it downstairs to him. Post up move for him off the side. Pumped in on for three. Fourth triple for Singapore. So trying to loosen up the Hong Kong defense on the interior. That's how to do it. 21-20. Singapore with a one-digit lead. The two, no good. Rebound by Irvin Tondo. Long lead pass to Howard and will be too late. Singapore Slingers taking the 21-20 lead at the end of the first stanza. Four triples, Michael Wong, for Singapore. That's more like it.
This is a very good sign for the Singapore Slingers. They, you know, this only shows that they're gaining the confidence to shoot from the outside, you know, taking some shots from the outside, and that will open up the interior where Howard will be able to do some low block action against Boone.
21-20 is your score, and that will do it at the end of the first quarter. We'll be right back. Previous score here. There's the takeaway by Ellie again. You can see Boone getting behind the defense. There's that pickoff again. Now remember, Boone had made the shot, Tyler Lamb had made the shot at the other end, or got the steal at the other end. So Lamb makes the shot, gets the steal, and a nifty little assist to Josh Boone, who finished it up. There's Coach Torres, he looking cool, calm, and collected as usual, but it's anything but that. So four triples, Michael Wong, to keep Singapore in the game. But good news, bad news sort of thing. You hit four three-pointers, you expect to be up by more than one. But as you say, what that might, the repercussions of that might open up things inside so that Alexander will be able to do his thing, dribble, penetrate, either kick back outside or take the ball through the glass itself. And Howard, they won't be able to perhaps double team on him, so that would be Boone one-on-one with Howard, and I like that.
Offensively, I think the Slingers are really doing a good job of getting everyone involved, as we spoke about prior to the game. But defensively, that's where I think they didn't lack the intensity and the identity that was sorely lacking right at the start of the season. You know, they were out like gangbusters on the defensive end, because that's where they built the identity. Because right now, I think the Hong Kong Long Lions are still getting to the basket, and they're still getting the shots they want in a very comfortable pace. That's why the Hong Kong Long Lions are actually shooting at a very high percentage.
They certainly are. We'll have those statistics to you in just a moment, as soon as they get relayed to us. Singapore on the offensive boards doing a fine job, especially the second part of the first quarter. So your point totals right now, Justin Howard with three, Go with two, and we do have the statistics right now as we get ready for second quarter. Slinger 7 of 20, so 35%, the 3 of 8 from beyond the arc. Richard in the game now, and he immediately coughs it up. We'll get those stats to you in just a minute. Alexander, and he is fouled. And that will go on number 8, Chan Sui Wing. So he is claiming he did not foul. Elliott also getting in the middle of it too. Looking at the rebounding, Singapore, 14 rebounds, 6 O-boards. There it is again, obvious push right there. In fact, that might have been Tong Chi, who had 4 fouls last game. As far as rebounds, 7 rebounds for Hong Kong Eastern Lions. So the Slingers doubling up, and especially on the O-boards, getting 6 to only 2 for Hong Kong. Hong Kong shooting 9 of 18, as you pointed out, Michael, 50% from the floor, so out shooting Singapore. Long three for Wong is good. Wong Wei Wong, his second triple of the game, and Singapore leads by 4, but again, Boone getting behind the defense. Can't finish it. Up again, still can't finish it. Howard comes away with the board. Singapore's got to watch that. Cannot afford to let him get behind. Erzin Tondo for 3. Back rims that one, not this time. So 1 and out. Elliott, left hand, getting the ball to Boone. Foul! That will go on Go. So the switch there had Go on Boone. Elliott finding that sort of a mismatch there. And watch it again. In fact, that is Ung Han Bin. So 6-5 going against 6-11. No doubt how that's going to finish off. But to Singapore's advantage, perhaps. Josh Boone, not the best of free throw shooters. In fact, when he was with the NBA New Jersey Nets, set new lows for percentage. Free throws 1 year, 38%. He played 4 years in total. In fact, started with the Nets in 2008. 0-2. So wasted trip on the line that time. Down goes Alexander in the heat. Back comes Singapore. Alexander, Howard working on the high post. And on the floor again, and a foul. Wow, a lot of fouls going by way of Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. watch it again. Let's see. And that is obviously right there, Tan Chi. I don't know what Coach Torres was going on about. Obvious grab that time. 8:56 to go here in the second quarter. And Torres, as good coaches do, will try and get his opinion expressed. With that seed of doubt in the back of the referee's mind. Wong with two threes already. Howard still up at the high post. And a walking call there. And that will be a charging call, they're going to say, with the elbows. So watch it again. Didn't really see the foul. I did see a travel, but I didn't see the foul. So Hong Kong will get the ball back. Talking about turnovers. Singapore with two in the first quarter, also long lines with two, but both teams doing a fairly good job of taking care of the ball. Grinchard in the game right now. Stephen Grinchard, long three is going to be off the mark, and Howard will rally the rebound. Back comes Urban Kongo. Howard. Howard is staying camped out more or less away from the basket. I don't know if that's by design or not. Downstairs it goes to Alexander. Grinchard on him, a foul. So fouls Michael Wong coming very fast and quick for Hong Kong. Watch it again. Grinchard and Alexander will take that matchup every time.
It seems like they're doing a role reversal for the Singapore Slingers. So we have X-Men at the low block and we have Howard actually at the high post area. You know, he's been able to hit that shot with consistency. So I guess that's the reason. One of the reasons why Coach Newport have that arrangement is that Josh Boone is actually outrunning Howard from rim to rim. You know, every single time there's a rebound, you know, he's off to the races. He's gonna beat Howard to the race and he's gonna be down there and it's gonna be an issue for the Slingers moving forth.
Good thing for the Slingers though, if they keep Howard at the high post and that allows Alexander to do what he does downstairs. Two of two, so Slingers with their biggest lead of the game. The 18 mark, 26 to 20. 6 of 7 from the line. Elliott. Somebody's got to be open and it's Tyler Lamb. Grinchard almost walked the ball back outside again. Slingers back in a, looks like a helping zone. Getting some separation now. The ball goes in the path of Boone. Quick pass over to Lamb. Over the right-hand side of three. Yes! You can see that coming. Tyler Lamb, deadly. He's got to have a hand in his face. There's been Tondo. You see Howard still away from the basket. Alexander basically playing the number five position. Inside it goes, knocked away by number two, Marcus Elliott. Good play on defense by him. Wong tries to pivot towards the basket. Singapore will have it with 7 left on the shot clock. Howard will take that shot. Missed it this time. Pushing off, I believe, by Lamb. Let's see. No, they're going to. Yeah, that's going to be Tyler Lamb on the push off. So that will be 3 on Tyler Lamb, I believe. Let's see. No. Watch it again. That was a push right there. Well, that's only 2 on Lamb. So Singapore with the ball again. And inbounds, it'll be Alexander. Cutting over is Erzman Tondo, almost steps out of bounds. Wong. Wong will take the 3, it'll be short on that. Rising for the rebound is Boone. Back comes Chan and company at the 7:18 mark. Working on Wong, he is going around the screen. Now right hand accelerating to Wong with a blocking foul. That'll be 2 on Wong Wei Long. So 6 points on Wong. There he is trying to get his way around the screen, but was forced too high. And then when Chan made his move, he was already in his path. So Wong now after the 3 personal fouls. Michael Johnson, the assistant coach, talking it over with him, and we will probably not see Wong the rest of the half. Singapore led by as many as 6, ditto for Hong Kong earlier on, and Singapore employing is what we saw, keeping Howard away from the basket. Michael was saying that Boone beating Howard down the court and able to get some cheap baskets as he did yesterday, 3 or 4 occasions, so Singapore don't want a reoccurrence of that. Chard, Boone, back outside to Elliott. Elliott rumbling to the basket, up and in. Nice hesitation move. Singapore's lead trimmed to one at the 7 minute mark. Alexander bounce pass over to Earthman Tondo. Build up on that right hand side. Alexander trying to get space downstairs and foul on Lamb, and that will be three on him. Interesting development. Tyler Lamb has his hands full against Xavier Alexander. Check it out. Tyler Lamb, 6'5". Alexander, about 6'6", or 6'7". So about an inch or two separation there. But, of course, Alexander a little bit more athletic than Lamb, and it showed that time. So Tyler in trouble now with the three fouls. Let's see how quickly they get him out. And, again, at the line will be the X-man, who was 6'7" from the line. One aspect of this game that he's picked up a lot in the 2016-17 season as opposed to last year when he was about a 50% free throw shooter. Tried to get a commitment from Alexander if he was considering trying to come back next year. Of course, that is so far in the future. You don't know. So, 3-point lead now, and he said he's really been enjoying his time here in Singapore. Loves the fans, loves the area, loves the food. That's a big plus. So we'll see. Elliott back over to Chan. Skip pass back to him. Back outside it goes. Lamb is on the bench, by the way. Long three. He's going to get it. Chan. Remember, he had 12. Check that. That is Lee Key. Three last game, so already matching that point total. This is where Hong Kong does have a good bench. Not saying that they don't miss Lamb, but look at that shot by Alexander. The quick spin move and a travel there by Irvin Tondo. A turnover there for Singapore. So 28 apiece. And again, Torres trying to get in the ears of the officials. So he won the foul. Elliott. Well, Torres has some swag now. He's coach of the year. Around the screen. Again, Chan and a foul, and that will be on Irvin Tondo. So Josh now with two. So perhaps you can see why. Look how close they throw that screen, sort of forcing Josh into the player. So smart move. Irvin Tondo will go off. Desmond O will come on, I believe, for the Slingers. Acceleration blocked by Alexander. Oh, Alexander and a travel. Easy call by the official, and my goodness, the turnovers coming in waves for the Singapore Slingers. They just, I think that's about the fifth traveling call we've seen on them the last couple of games. So Alexander, rightly so, his eyes lit up, but he moved his feet at the same time. Tie game. Boom, a little bit out of his range. Unkin Han, who is now checked into the game with the rebound. Alexander again. Howard on the opposite side. Now in a more traditional position. Draws a crowd immediately. Wide open look. Trying to force the ball up and in. Unkin Han. So Singapore now with a 2-point lead. That was Fleck, actually. Elliott dancing from right to left now in the lane. Gives it up to Richard, who's a good outside shooter, not this time. Stephen Grinchard, the French Hong Kong citizen, went to school in the U.S. Alexander back outside. Not this time. That was a shot that Howard was hitting with regularity yesterday. 31 points, I counted 13 points from outside. Chan to Grinchard again. Back to Chan around the screen. Quet off the dribble and a blocking foul, and that will go on Quet. Coach Ngo wanted the offensive foul, and I guess you could make your case either way. So good anticipation. Watch it again. Switching to the right hand. There you go. Yeah. So good move by Chan on the switch. Timeout by the Slingers. They lead 30-28. When we come back, Chan will be at the line. And Michael, Singapore Slinger, is still, you know, they're making some turnovers at some inopportune times, but doing a good job by and large on the offensive end and the defensive end, which we would expect by then. But still employing that strategy, not going with Howard too deep and keeping him right around the high post, but midway between the high and low post, trying to jockey for position, and that way sort of neutralizing Boone at the moment anyway.
Yeah, I think that's a very strategic plan for the Snow Slingers right now. But I think I noticed something. Howard seems to be very, very hesitant right now. He's very inactive on the offensive end. I'm not sure if I'm seeing it correctly. He seems to be running on a little bit of a limp, and he's kind of it seems like he's being affected by his hamstrings. So because if you have a hamstring injury, it's hard for you to run up and down, and that's why Boone is actually, you know, getting a hit in the fast breaks.
Well, remember he had a turf toe about a month ago that sidelined him for a couple of games. You sort of wonder if that could be an issue. Very tough injury to get over, but I saw him limp one time a little bit earlier in the game, and if his mobility is hampered at all, then that would answer a lot of questions on why he is lining up so far away from the basket. But also the effect that has on Josh Boone is he has to stay with Howard. We saw Howard take a lot of shots from outside yesterday or day before yesterday as well. I don't know if he was hampered by injury or not, but we'll keep an eye on that. So Chen, nothing but net the first one. That gets Hong Kong within one. 4:38 to go here in the first half. Chuck Schreiner along with Michael Wong here at the OCBC Arena. Game 4 of the ABL Finals for 2016-2017. So happy you could spend part of your Sunday with us. Quek off to Alexander. All the way downstairs to Ung, who thought about it. He's got Boone on him. Wide open look now, and can't get it. Howard underneath. Oh, get it out of here, says Boone, and off to the races goes number 8, Chan. Winchard backing up, Fong back into the game. Rotation, good ball movement by Hong Kong as they back it up. 12 on the shot clock. Chen around one defender, accelerates, gets the ball picked off in the lane by Ung. Lead pass to Alexander. Alexander still, knifey, go up and in. Good move by the X-Man. You can see the Hong Kong defenders thinking that the pass might go over to Howard. It didn't. So Singapore noses out in front again by 2. Chen. A lot of Hong Kong starters on the bench at the moment, including Elliott getting a blow. Back up jumper by Fong is way off the mark. Back again comes Alexander. The 3:30 mark. Skip over to Desmond O. Alexander posts up move on Grinchard. He'll turn and get it downstairs to Howard. Howard needs it too. So Alexander drawing the double team. Howard getting it on the left-hand side. No doubter for him. Slingers up by 4. Timeout by Hong Kong. They'll make some adjustments. Watch it again. Inside to Howard, and I guess he was wanting the foul on Grinchard for holding on. Did not get it. Another angle of it. Oh, he wanted it on Fong holding on. See that quite clearly, so the referee's missing that call right there. And Singapore Slingers fans having something to shout about here as they have the 4-point lead with 3:21 to go, Michael. And really nothing to tell between these two. You got to like the strategy, however, of Hong Kong able to rest Elliott for periods of time because they know they're going to need him down the stretch, and the local guys doing a pretty good job of filling it in.
The last two games is very evident that Coach Torres has been very, very daring to, you know, to get his imports out for a good breather, and especially in between the quarters. So right now it's the same thing. He took both Lam and Allen out of the game with 3:20 remaining in the first half. You know, that game is still very much tight in a sense because it's only a 4-point lead. He's just hoping that his players, his local players, can hold the fort in these 3 minutes. You know, to get the lead, get ballooned up to double digits. And heading into the second half, you know, at least his bowling parts are well rested. His imports are rested. You know, they can come out strong in the second half.
Well, we saw that same sort of scenario in game 2 when it was very, very close. Elliott was ejected from the game, and the local guys, and we're talking about Fong Shiyi, number 12, Chan Sui Wing, and Tong Chi, and Lee Ki. All of them doing an admirable job keeping Hong Kong afloat and eventually coming away with that 8-point lead. And also figuring mightily in those turnovers. Remember, we keep talking about those 25 and 22 turnovers, that smirch on Singapore's record. 47 turnovers, very unslinger-like. Elliott back into the game now, holding the ball, and he is fouled by Quet. And the fans don't like that at all. So let's watch it again. Holding foul on Leon. And for Leon, that will be two on him as we watch it. Boy, it looked like all ball to me.
Looks clean.
Wow. Wow. So referee calling that from behind the play. That's never a good sign. Referee who is in best vision down on the baseline swallowed his whistle. So Elliott at the line. Chance to bring Hong Kong within two. Very loud Singapore crowd, but Elliott misses the first one, so who knows. Boone was at the line the last time down. He missed two. You just joined us. Elliott crowned the World Import Most Valuable Player for 2016-2017. Second in the league in scoring, averaging 24.9 points a game. Picked away, Irvin Tondo. Ball. Finish, Jeff. Jeff like that. Another turnover. So an inopportune time, it seems, every game, Michael Wong. Singapore making silly mistakes. Full court pressure by Hong Kong. Irvin Tondo being trapped. Finally founding Quet. Quet, the pull-up jumper from the free throw line. Good. So three-point lead again. Elliott now. Still Elliott. Backs it up. Bong will check back into the game. Now the ball in the hands of Chan. They'll spread out the defense a little bit. Bong, bounce pass inside. Oh, to Boone. That's beautiful. Threading the needle pass. Boone finishing up that quick release. Right under the nose of Justin Howard. A little skip pass inside. Irvin Tondo looking for Howard. He'll back it back out again. Now will come Howard. Irvin Tondo finding the crease, thought about it. Inside four on the shot clock. Wide open look for Alexander. Going to be off the mark, but offensive board by Quick. Opposite side now. Irvin Tondo for three. Going to be off the mark. Rebound. Elliott. Irvin Tondo ahead of him. He'll slow it up. Chance for Hong Kong to take the lead. Ball knocked away. Howard stepping in the lane. Lead pass. Going to be too far, and Alexander can't stop it. So turnover, and then a turnover on the other end. Well, right idea, but the lead pass is just too far, and Alexander running out of real estate. So 1:42 to go. Singapore dodging the bullet there. So back comes Chan and company. Oh, here comes the screen by Boone. Another screen. Nice acceleration. High off the glass. Tipped out right in the path of Howard. Lead pass. Alexander will take it to the house, but it's fouled. That will go on Lee Key. Good foul by Lee. But that'll be three on him, I believe. Watch it again. So take your pick there. Give him the easy two or make him earn it from the line. But the downside of that, if you're in Hong Kong, is their second player who's got three fouls, and it is Lee Key joining Tyler Lamb. Michael Johnson having some words with Irvin Tondo, who's been a little bit out of control from time to time, Michael. I know he's got the two threes, but sometimes, you know, players try to do too much. You want to win so bad, you try and do too much. And, X, who has been almost perfect at the line today.
He just jinxed him.
Yeah, just jinxed him. I knew I shouldn't have said that. Got to be even-handed though, right? Yeah. So 1:22 to go here in the second quarter. Got the second one. Singapore goes up by a couple of digits. Char checking back into the game. Long pass downstairs to Boone. Doing a good job. Howard had interception on his mind. And Char, the little finger roll in the lane. Well, tied up at 37. To get underneath a minute. Irvin Tondo. Howard. Alexander. Thought about it. Good shard on him. Post-up move for him. That'll be a two if it goes. It does not. Skine for the rebound. It's Grinchard. He'll come down with it. 45 seconds. Chance for Elliott and company to go up now. He'll hold it up. Bounce pass inside. Boone loses it. Out of bounds it goes. Last touch by Singapore. So Hong Kong will have it underneath their own basket with 38-4 to go. We've got an interesting halftime show for you. Maybe an interview or two, and Mike and I will talk about the Slinger season picks as far as the way we look at it. So want to hang around for our halftime festivities here, and the, will be the last game that we bring you here at the OCBC Arena. We want to thank all of our loyal fans for sticking with us. 13 games in total we did here on Arena Sports Hub. Great result for the Slingers, making it all the way to the finals again, but can they clear that last hurdle and bring that elusive title to the Lion City of Singapore? Coach Ngo designing something. It looks like a screen down low, and maybe to free up Alexander. And on the other side of the ball, Josh Boone has been a little bit quiet in the first half, as has Howard. Howard, we mentioned, only with 3 points, and Boone with only 5. So you wonder, Mike, you were surmising that maybe, just maybe, Justin Howard carrying a little bit of an injury.
Yeah, he seems really, really very hesitant on both ends. I mean, defensively, he's not as his active self. I mean, he's grabbing rebounds at a high rate, but the thing is, defensively, he's not rotating as well as the previous three games. And when he gets up and down the court, it seems like he's going to pick up his legs.
You mentioned he had that turf toe before, but could be a hamstring issue, or maybe it's nothing. Anyway, we're keeping our eye on it. Okay. Inbounds to Grinchard. Grinchard has Elliott circling around. They'll get the ball to him. 9 on the shot clock. Alexander. Crossover inside. Little pull-up jumper with the separation. Oohs and ahs from the crowd. And Elliott, a master at doing that. So Hong Kong with the 2-point lead. The shot clock is turned off. Singapore will try and get the last shot. In trouble now. They have to step it up a little bit. 10 seconds left. Don't want a turnover now. Quack loses control of the ball and gets bailed out at the end. A hand looked like Boone touching it. So 4.5 to get something going. Watch it again, and there's where he loses control. Out was Elliott, got his hand on it at the end. So you wish he kept his hands down that one time. Off the dribble, inside. Way off the mark, and that will do it. So the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions do enough to have a 2-point lead. They'll carry that into the dressing room. 39-37, very evenly matched game. Both teams led by as many as 6 during the first quarter. Was mostly Hong Kong and Singapore coming back to take a 6-point lead. We have Justin Howard only with 5 points, Alexander with 9. And we'll come back with our halftime festivities, 39-37 in favor of Hong Kong when we return.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
39-37 in favor of the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions over the Singapore Slingers here at the OCBC Arena, the Lion City of Singapore, as we look at a whole bunch of 5 to 7-year-olds exhibiting their skills. Well, here's what we came to see, these guys exhibiting their skills. There is Marcus Elliott for 3 of his first half 13 points. Alexander trying to get something going, stop and pop from the elbow or thereabouts. 9 points for him in the first half. And pretty much like this, Elliott with the lead pass to Boone, and we've seen that a lot. And that's the point where we saw Justin Howard not moving real well down the court. Little steal there by Alexander. Long three by Irvin Tondo, who has 8. Those were 3 of his 8 points. He hit a couple of threes in the lane again. Very active, but losing the ball. And then getting it back is Irvin Tondo. He gets some separation. Fortuitous flow of events for him. His second triple. Philippine fans will like him. There is a pass picked off momentarily. Great hustle there by Tyler Lamb. Look at the recognition there by Elliott to hit Boone as he flashes towards the basket in the trail position. Yeah. Wong Wei Long lighting it up for Singapore, who were 4 of 14 from beyond the arc. That's much better than what they were the other day, 2 of 15. Ball off the side of the rim, and Tyler Lamb again, who is playing now with 3 fouls. The Coach Torres sat him down after he got that 3rd foul, so look for him to come back and be a factor in the second half. Elliott full head of steam. Wow. The MVP showing how to get it done, surrounded by white jerseys. Good recognition there by Howard, and in a crowd is Leon Kwek, staying strong with his move to the basket. Dumping it into Alexander. Alexander, Grinchard on him. Oh yes, finding Howard as a 2 players go on him. He is left untouched, and again, wanting the foul. He didn't get it that time either. Little bounce pass inside. Good job finding Boone. Nice job by number 12. That was Fong Xinyun. So 39-37. Oh, yes, one more for good measure. Another 2 of his 13 points. So Elliott and his team with the 2-point lead. Okay, field goal percentage. Look at this. 32% for Singapore. 47 for the Long Lions, but yet it's a 2-point game. Go figure. Rebounds the way of Singapore. That might explain a lot of it. 26 for Singapore. They have a 10-point bulge over the Long Lions. Turnover 7-5. Much better for Singapore than the other days. And 9 assists to 6. Of course, Long Lions led the league in assists. So recap of the 2016 game, game 4, when the same Singapore Slingers play the Malaysian Dragons here at the OCBC Arena. Hope you enjoy this. That's the shot that he usually will take. Ooh, little one-handed jumper off the top. Singapore got. Xavier, not known as a great outside shooter, he will be getting the room. Rosales underneath, wide open look for Howard. Howard turns by. That's the shot. Quickly given off to Rosales. Rosales cut down. Little show and go. And the right looking on Lou. There's the screen by Calvin. Little fadeaway shot there off the hole. Ball stripped away by Desmond Owens. Open court, 3-on-2. Off to Howard. Howard, 2 steps to the back. Up and in off the back. Taken by Malaysia again. So another offensive ball and roll. What we have here, overcommitting on defense by Wu. Long shot from downtown. Wu swings it over to the X-Man, trying to find some space. Oh, yes! Got it in line. My goodness! Wu ahead of him. Switches to the left hand. Howard wide open look. Got it! Running the Malaysia offense. Wright gets the separation. Fires up and in. Alexander bounced past to Howard. Howard, Wu, started to come baseline, but changes course and goes back outside. He hit a little turn and shoot for Howard. It's good. Alexander, pass to Howard, gets past one defender up and in. It's good. Goes in. The ball falls into the path of Howard, but leaks on the floor, picked up by Bai. Long three, yes, count it. Ace Black on the right side. Bai off the mark, stepping in to get the offensive board, though, is Howard. Good position by him. Rosales from the elbow, yes. Howard, Johnson working on him. Ball's on the floor, almost lost it. Long, way downtown. Oh, my goodness. Long, way long. Game clock is off. Here comes the kick back outside. Wong's going to have to let it go at the buzzer. Yeah! Hope you enjoy that little look back at the future. Singapore with a dramatic win. Wong Wei Long getting the key shot in a 75-73 victory. Let's go over to Elliot Danker, our man on the court.
Thank you, Chuck. End-to-end action right here at the OCBC Arena. Such an exciting game. And you know, the one thing that makes these games so exciting are the fans. I got a couple of super fans joining me. Kim and family, come on in. Obviously supporting Team Singapore. How long have you been a basketball fan, Kim?
I've been a fan since secondary school days.
Wow, that's really exciting. And you got your whole family down. In fact, your wife was more excited than you. She was on her feet the entire time.
Yeah, both my wife and our daughter, very excited about this game today.
Hong Kong East Long Lions at halftime leading by just 2 points. How's your faith in our Singapore Slingers?
I think with the fan support, the Slingers will come back and win this game, and as well as win the championship in Hong Kong.
Excellent stuff. It is going to happen. Who's your favorite Slingers player?
Wei Long.
Oh, Wong Wei Long, number five. Well, the third period is starting in just a couple of minutes. It's back to you, Chuck.
Thank you, Elliot. And Michael Wong and I will play a little game. We hope you'll enjoy this. And we're gonna talk about Singapore picks for the season 2016-2017. Michael, I'm going to throw one at you. World Import of the Year, and your opinion on the Slingers.
Wow, that's a tough call. I guess statistically-wise, I will give it to Howard.
Howard. Yeah. I concur. A very, very close call. X-Man's had a terrific season, 19 points, a couple of triple-doubles along the way. But Howard, whenever they need a basket, he is there. Let's switch gears a little bit. The best local player on the team, a Singaporean player who you think has made the most impact for 2016-17.
Wow. This is even tougher because, I mean, a lot of them have very decent games every now and then. You know, somebody will pop out of the blue, you know, carry the team for a while, carry the load for a while. So, consistency basis-wise, I guess I would still give it to Wei Long. Yeah.
Wei Long. I'll be contrarian just for this one time. I'm going to say Leon Kwek for me. I think he's the future of Singapore basketball. He's shown me enough to get the award just in my point of view. Okay, hope you've enjoyed that, fans. Tell you what, let's go away for a break, and we'll be right back for the second half in a moment. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We have a barn burner here at the OCBC Arena, 39-38, game four of the ABL Finals. Best of five series. If Singapore wins, they force a game five in Hong Kong. That'll be on Tuesday night. And if Singapore should lose, the unthinkable, then Hong Kong on Singapore's home court will hoist the trophy. And they will be the winners 3-1. Justin Howard, as we said before, hasn't been the offensive force that we have been used to seeing. But another thing I was wondering about, Michael, you know, he played two nights ago, less than 48 hours. So you wonder if any of these guys are going to really have the energy that they had a couple of days ago. Not much rest in between. Alexander with the ball. Oh, takes it inside. Can't hit the layup. Rebound by Fong. Gets the ball off to Elliott. Hong Kong business here. Start the third quarter. Desmond Oh in the game. Now really going at number eight, Chen Sui Wing, and fouling right away. Chen Sui Wing, 24 years of age, 6'1". He's listed as a forward, but does most of his damage at the guard position. Very good ball handler. He can shoot the ball too, in case you didn't know. It's yesterday, 12 points. Elliott to check it in. Oh, offensive foul right there. Crowd likes that. We'll watch it again. There's the elbow swinging up with the shoulder, catching Desmond Oh. So turnabout fair play. Desmond Oh fearless on defense. Josh Erzman Tondo. Delvin going the game. Josh Boone getting into it with Alexander. What do we have here? Erzman Tondo having to be led away by Desmond Oh, too. I'm not sure. Offsetting fouls. Let's see how this thing started. Ooh, right there. There's the foul by Elliott, I guess.
I think they call it a double foul. And then they call an unsportsmanship foul on, I'm not sure who.
Maybe Boone. Erzman Tondo looks like he's going to go to the free throw line. Elliott trying to get clarification as well. Shades of game two. Erzman Tondo saying, look at my eye. He was bumped right into me. And the officials, here comes Coach Torres over getting dry in the middle of it, and the fans don't want any part of that, and the referee's trying to get him back to his bench, and he better go over there. You don't want to compound the situation, Michael, and give yourself a T. Right now they're trying to sort things out at the scorer's table, and we'll wait until the official call comes in, but it looks like a double foul, and then an unsportsmanlike conduct foul, so that will put Erzman Tondo at the line for a pair, and Singapore will get the ball. Maybe just two, and then Hong Kong will get the ball. It depends on how they score this. So Josh at the line for a pair. He has to try and tie it up, and Boone and Alexander don't seem too upset about it, so I don't think there's any hard feelings.
Yeah, I think the unsportsmanship foul is actually on Elliott as well. So right now, his foul tally is actually a four. He got called for a personal, double personal foul.
Well, I'm looking, he's got four fouls. Yeah. He's got four fouls, so. Elliott with four. Lamb with three, and Erzman Tondo will go to the bench to get seen to. The Slingers, I believe, will have the ball. Now, Elliott going over and saying, I'm looking up and I'm seeing four fouls. Did you give me two fouls? And he's saying, I think they'll take one foul off, actually. I think he only has three fouls, not four. I think the bench's understanding of it was the referees were giving a double foul on Elliott. But so far, no change. So Coach Torres looking a little bit disappointed. Slingerport will have the ball now. And the four fouls stay in the ledger on Elliott. So that there's another foul. And that will go on Chan Sui Wing. one thing to be aggressive, but watch this. Now that's just, that's an obvious foul, Michael. So number eight, Charles Wee-Wink, he now has three fouls. Howard coming way outside. Bounce pass over to Wong, who gives it up to Desmond O. Desmond O now. Still Desmond O, and he is fouled, pushing on Fong. Wow. So that's three on Fong. Watch it again. Well, I don't know about that. A little bit whistle happy, I think. I didn't really see the foul. I'd have to agree with Fong on that one. Okay, so Desmond O at the line to shoot two to try and break the tie here, 39 apiece. He misses the first one. Coach Torres just crowned Coach of the Year. Misses them both, stepping in the lane and picking it off. They've changed Elliott's to three fouls, so there is some justice in the world. Elliott dumps the pass in. Ball on the floor. Howard will pick it up momentarily, and he's fouled by Fong. So four on Fong. No, they're going to say Boone. Boone is saying, me, I was nowhere around. I thought the foul was on Fong that time. Let's watch it again. There's a push from behind, maybe, is what they're referring to, Boone. So Josh Boone now with three. Elliott with three. Lamb with three, Fong with three. There's a conversion. So a very seismic shift in the foul situation now in the first couple of minutes. Actually, a minute and 2 seconds all this has happened. One of two, and boom. Crowd wanting a goaltending there. We're not going to get it. Thought Boone moved a little bit too early with the rebound. 1 point lead for Singapore. Elliott swings the ball down to Grinchard. Back out to Elliott. Right hand. There's a screen. Long three is going to be off mark. Good position by Howard to get it. Back comes Singapore. Wong. He's playing with three fouls. The only Singapore player with foul trouble. Downstairs going straight at Boone. Wild shot there. Boone gets the rebound. Outlet pass to Grinchard. Back in the hands of Elliott. So trying to quickly get the foul on Boone. Nice screen by Boone. The three is no good for Elliott. Ball safely in the hands of Wong Wei Long now. Singapore still nursing the 1 point lead. Ball knocked away. And a ball handling foul by Wong. So a turnover. That would be turnover number eight for the Slingers. They have kept their turnovers in check for the most part, Singapore has. Remember, last game they had 22, the game before that 25. So Fong and Chan bringing the ball down. Just under 8 minutes, Elliott around the screen. Elliott accelerates in the lane, kick back outside to Fong, who misses the shot. Boone with the rebound, offensive board on the floor. Nice job by Lamb to keep control of it. Up he goes. Great control by Lamb. Hong Kong up again by one. Tyler Lamb dancing inside the key, finding the lane, and somehow getting that ball home. Alexander. Wong, he'll take the three. He's already hit two, not this time. Ball up in the air, right into the hands of Go. Now downstairs to Howard, up and in. Shooters roll there, they'll take it. Singapore again with the 1 point lead. Howard now with eight. Around the screen, Elliott accelerates, fires. Can't get it to fall, and another rebound for Howard, who is moving very, very slowly down the court. Wow, there's that limp you were talking about, Michael. So obviously playing in some discomfort. There's been Stondo over to Howard. Downstairs to Alexander. Back outside. He thought about it. Bumping against Boone and gets the roll. So finally Howard in double figures. 44-41. Nice little layup move that time by Howard. Lamb. 6:30 mark. Loses his defender. Now he's got the mismatch that he wanted with the slow-footed Go up and in off the left side. Great move by Lamb. Singapore up by one. Bruce Bentondo passing for clearing out on the left-hand side. Howard at the high post. Still Howard. He's got Go on the right side. Bruce Bentondo for three is going to be off the mark. Go with the rebound. Howard. Yes. Right behind the free throw line. That's where Howard operates. Very smooth. 12 now for Howard. Elliott being chased by Alexander. Still Elliott pushing off. Screen by Boone. Inside, throwing it away. Last touch by Singapore. So Hong Kong will have the ball with 11 seconds left on the shot clock. So very, very physical game. None of it mean-spirited at all. They're both, it's a very physical game, but a very clean game so far, Michael.
Yeah, both teams are really fighting very hard for right now in the third quarter. You know, this is where the momentum shifts. You know, you get a good lead here. You know, the whole team will get a good momentum going fourth quarter.
Boom to Elliott. Key for three. And that will tie it. Lee Key playing the three fouls. Downstairs it goes. Kick back outside immediately. Now finding Alexander. Fong working on him with three fouls. Long three by one. It's going to be off the mark. Boom, skies get the board. The Hong Kong opportunity here to go up. Elliott will slow it down. Boom will rotate to the right side. Land down on the low post. Wong working on him. That might be something to keep an eye on. Inside, Boom. Boom, quick move. As the ball knocked out of his hand, that will go on Howard. So Justin with two fouls now. We hit the 5:04 mark of the third quarter. Watch it again. There it is. On the non-shooting hand. So timeout called by Singapore as we are locked 46-46. Remember, Hong Kong had the 40-39 lead going into the half, so a very low scoring affair, Michael.
Yeah, effort-wise, you really cannot fault them. You know, both of them are fighting very hard, and this is their fourth game. And schedule has been really packed, and they've been giving it all out for the last three games. And man, it's no wonder, you know, you will say, you wonder how much left in the tank for the players right now. Yeah, this is really gut check time. They're going to lay it all out there. For the seniors, it's a do or die. They got to lay it all out there, because if they leave anything on the court, they're not going to get a chance anymore. They got to fight to go back to Hong Kong.
Remember that if there is a game five in Hong Kong, that's Tuesday, so only a two-day turnaround. Today's Sunday, so Singapore will probably be late tonight, early tomorrow. They'll only have 1 day to recover. So both these teams, if you say gut check time, fitness plays a big, big hand in it. Both these teams supremely fit. So who can hold their nerve and who can be the last man standing, as they say? 46-46, and they are playing for that right there, the ASEAN League Trophy. Neither one of these teams have won it. Singapore, close enough to smell it last year. They went all the way the fifth game, going down to Westport Malaysian Dragons in a game five in KL. And of course, this is Hong Kong's first season. There's Coach Torres. He's done a magnificent job getting his team this far. And they are just this game away from winning the trophy and taking it home to Hong Kong on Singapore's court. Inbound. Bounce pass inside, knocked away. Boom. Tyler Lamb, he's got a mismatch. Let's keep an eye on this. Good job by Howard with a weak side help. Long shot is no good. Erz Matondo standing in the lane to pick it off. Bounce pass ahead and kick ball by Boone. Tried to get the lead pass inside Alexander. It was short, actually. So Singapore will have the ball underneath their own basket with 21 left on the shot clock. Here it goes in the open court. There it is by Wu Boy, who did kick it away. There it is, wide open look from the left-hand side. In and out it goes. Boone clears it out. Gets the ball over to Elliott. So Elliott accelerates. Turn into a half-court game by both these teams. Teams aren't turning the ball over. What do we have here? A foul. Reaching in, I believe, by Desmond O. If it is, that'll be two on him. So a foul to give. Let's watch it again. Here's Elliott. In fact, it might be the X-Man. There, boy, that's a ticky-tack foul, isn't it? So the X-Man now with two. Lamb, Desmond Oh. Remember, Lamb operating with three fouls. Spin move, high off the glass, no good. The tip by Boone, no good. Irvin Tondo, and Hong Kong will remain possession. Guy coming out on the court and retrieving the ball, gets a nice hand. Thought we saw that gentleman on TV last week as well. He's been in the right place at the right time twice. Ellie, Alexander, Tyler Lamb. Wow, little drop step move on Howard, and 2-point lead now for Hong Kong. 4:06 mark. Irvin Tondo, Howard lurking on the high post. Alexander, rotation over to Irvin Tondo, way off the mark. My goodness, and a foul. So Singapore's turn to make silly fouls this time. I don't understand Irvin Tondo with a quick hand on that particular play, Michael.
You know, I'm seriously wondering if the referees are trying to balance the whistle. Because the first 1 minute, the fouls were all on Hong Kong long lines. You know, they went to 16 fouls in 1 minute. So right now, I don't know. It seems like it.
Fong gets the first one. So long lines, forging a nifty little 3-point lead. That's the biggest lead that Singapore has enjoyed here in the third quarter as well. Make it 4. So Singapore, a little bit of a cold streak at the moment. Irvin Tondo is it too quick. Back over to Josh. Howard still at the high post area. Swings it to Ung Bin Hong. Jumps it into Howard. Irvin Tondo. Good pursuit by Hong Kong. 5 on the shot clock. Inside it goes, and ball stripped away. It'll go Hong Kong's way. So a turnover for Singapore. Not able to get a shot off. Opportunity here for Hong Kong to stretch the lead. They've led by as many as 6 that we have inside the lane. And Tyler Lamb with the quick hands to force the turnover. Elliott again. Alexander closer. Elliott in the lane. Foul. That might go on Howard. If it is, that'll be number 2 on him. No, it'll be Desmond Oh. Watch it again. That's Ung Bin Hong, they're going to say it's a game. You can see Elliott knifing in between 2 defenders. So Elliott will be at the line. Excellent opportunity. And sort of get the feeling, Michael, just watching Hong Kong slowly but surely wearing down Singapore.
It seems that the Hong Kong Lions are getting a little bit better in their momentum. They're really handling the pressure right now.
Elliott, the just crowned MVP. It's the first of 2. He's got 14 points now. And the 13. 1 out of 2. So 5-point lead. Singapore needing a score. Quick. Back over to Alexander. With another shot to be off the mark again. Lead pass, here comes Elliott. Same script, once again, dumping the ball into Boone. Boone has a mismatch inside and a foul. Wow. So Singapore getting caught in mismatches. Watch it again, that's Melvin Goh and Quek trying to get a hand in. So Boone will be at the line for 2. Not a good free throw shooter, as he has demonstrated. So 5-point lead. Irvin Tondo will exit the game. And again, I think it's just another example of Josh trying to do too much sometimes. Did have the wide open look, but sometimes if it's not going for you, you need to pass it up to somebody else. So 6-point lead at the 2:55 mark for the Hong Kong Long Lions. Matching their biggest lead of the game. Off the mark. Delvin Goh in the lane. Wong. Quick. Wong again. There's the screen. Pull up jumper is going to be off the mark again. Again, one and out for Singapore. They cannot buy a bucket. Ice cold from the floor. Chan, check back. Quick will draw him. triple go around. And they look for another one. Up top, the pull-up jumper from the elbow. If it goes, it counts. Another foul. So Chan Swee Wing will go to the line. Watch it again. Here's Leon Kwek trying to get in between the screen and the player. Desmond O will check in. Kwek will go out. And my goodness, Shays, what we saw last game, all of a sudden, everybody on the team going ice cold, Michael.
Yeah, the Long Island's actually converted into a change into a 3-2 zone defense on the Singapore Slingers. And this is where they need to hit some shots from the outside. And because the presence of Howard and Lopez is no existence right now.
One of two, 7-point lead now. So slightly pulling away. Wong quickly downstairs to Alexander. He's going to have to make something happen trying to go around. Dumps it off to Howard. Great job. Great recognition. That's more like a 5-point lead. And quickly back from Hong Kong. Lamb thought about it. Boom. In between two defenders. Can't get it to fall. Howard, lead pass. Over to Alexander. Alexander to finish. 3-point game. 4-point little mini run for Singapore. 1:49 to go here in the third quarter. First turnover for Hong Kong in a long, long time. Excellent job of taking care of the ball. Chan. There's that screen again. Boom. Circling downstairs. A long three. Skying up to get the ball. Lead pass to Wong. Wong on the right hand side. Passes it over. Long three for Kwek. The three. Singapore coming all the way back from the 7-point advantage or deficit. They have tied it up. Coach Torres will have to talk it over. Up-tempo game for the Singapore Slingers. Michael off the turnover, hitting the basket. Alexander hitting two shots and then the kick out in the easy three there for Desmond O. Seems like Desmond O, whenever they need a basket, he's there to supply the energy.
One way to break a zone is to push the ball up really fast. I mean, defensively, I thought Delvin really played a big role. He secured the two defensive rebounds that actually led to this three-pointer and the fast break by Alexandra.
Lamb there, you can see, really not going towards the shooter was number 8, Chan Swee Wing, and Desmond making him pay for it. Desmond, as we said before, more of a defensive specialist. He doesn't average a lot of points, but it just seems like whenever they need a bucket, he's the one that provides it. So good stuff from the Slingers. A little 7-0 run by them to erase that deficit. And they're right back in the thick of things and getting the crowd, more importantly, back into the game at 1:24 to go. We're keeping track of the scorers here. Alexander with 11, Howard with 11, Go with 2, but Mike was saying a couple of big rebounds. There's been Tondo with 10, but some ill-conceived shots the last couple of times. Wong with 6. Oh, only with 2, but none bigger than the last one that he took. And Wong Wei Long with 5. On the other side, the ball, 14 for Elliott. Lee with 8. Josh Boone only with, well, he's got 3. So here we go again. Elliott, nice and through, gets the ball over to Tyler Lamb for the finish. Tyler lurking on the baseline, gliding over, getting the pass from Elliott. Elliott doing it all. Alexander at the 1 minute mark. Wong around one screen, gets inside, gives it over to Go. Go puts it on the ground, up and in. Tapped by Howard, I believe, but no, they're going to say Go. Got the roll for 55 apiece. Delvin Go starting to assert himself on the offensive end. Elliott now. Momentarily the ball knocked away. Now he kicks it. Stolen away by Alexander. Alexander will take it home. Go for the layup. Up and in. Elliott on the turnover. Don't see that very often. Elliott now again. O will pick him up. Alexander to Boone. Boone stepping up. Now to Lamb. Lamb looking against Delvin Go. Kick back outside. Elliott from Threesville. No good. Howard with the rebound. Long outlet pass. Alexander will take it to the house. Singapore by 4. Shot at the buzzer. Going to be off. Singapore will take a 4-point lead. into the end of the third quarter and listen to this crowd. Well, the X-Man leading the charge, Michael, doing what he's been doing the entire 2 years he was here. Singapore on a 9-2 run. 59-55, they lead at the end of three quarters and doing just everything right. Just when we thought Hong Kong was going to pull away, a couple of very, very unfortunate turnovers for Hong Kong, one way to look at it. But here's that last play. Boone trying to chase to no avail, and laying it in is the X-Man. Another angle. Just what the doctor ordered. So Singapore, as we said, if they could just cut down on their turnovers, get some more guys involved with the offense, they stood a fighting chance, and that's exactly what's happened, Michael. 4-point lead. Singapore's got to be feeling pretty good of themselves going into the last 10 minutes.
And defensively, they really got to hold their own, because if you want to get a transition basket on your end, you got to make a stop. And it doesn't work well when someone scores on you, you know, it slows down the game. But when someone, when you get the defensive rebound, that's where you can actually push the ball up as fast as possible, you know, try to run on them, get a transition easy basket like what I've been seeing for the past 2 minutes.
Singapore, just when we thought, when they were committing a lot of fouls, it just seemed like every time you turn around, there'd be another Hong Kong player at the foul line. A couple of untimely turnovers also by Singapore got them in a ditch. They were down by 7. But very responsive on their offensive end, defensive end, as Michael Wong was saying. The stats, not pretty for Singapore. 21-56, only 38% on the other side of the ball, 21-49. Marginally better, 43% for Hong Kong. Look at the rebounds, 38 rebounds, including 13 offensive boards for Singapore. 28 rebounds for Hong Kong, 7 of those offensive boards. 3-point line, 5-21 for Singapore, better than the other day, 24%. 5-17 for Hong Kong. And the turnovers, 8 for Hong Kong, 7 for Singapore. So that's got to be encouraging news for the Slingers.
Not only that, look at the bench points. It's actually 13 for the Singapore Slingers and 5 for the Hong Kong Long Lions. No, this is way better than a game 3 where there was basically nothing from the bench.
Good point, Michael. And Hong Kong to inbound, or is it Singapore to inbound it? The X-Man and Fong getting tied up, and Elliott and Alexander seem to have some banter going. Elliott will take the ball. Last 10 minutes, buckle up, ladies and gentlemen. Last 10 minutes of our home coverage here of the Singapore Slingers at the OCBC Arena. There's Lamb with the ball. A little sideways pass inside. Pull-up jumper is no good by Fong. X-Man there with the rebound. Off to Wong Wei Long. Now to Alexander again. See if Howard's more active the fourth quarter. Way up top again, looking for somebody, looking for cutters. Swinging it around to Alexander. Alexander, quick move by him. Howard all alone, can't make it go, and a push off by Delvin Goh, I believe. No. See if they're going to get the foul to a push. Going to be on Elliott. That's 4 on Elliott. Wow. Well, I don't think they can afford to take him out of the game right now. They may just let nature run its course. We'll see. 4 on the best player on the court. He's in the eyes of the voter for the most valuable player award. Pass downstairs. Dangerous pass. Ball kicked. So Singapore will retain possession. They'll only have 6 seconds in which to do something with the ball. Hong Kong implying a couple of different zones on Singapore throughout this little mini tournament here. Desmond Oh downstairs to Go again. Go lowers his head, kicks the ball out to Howard. Howard, little show and go move inside, has the ball knocked out of his hands. 4 now on the shot clock. Fong wanting a foul, not going to get it. Elliott has to separate them. There you have it right there. He's won the offensive foul, and I'm not so sure if he doesn't have a case. They're knocked away by Fong. So 4 seconds, Singapore is going to have to do something quickly, and the referee not going to blow a foul, just trying to get the players to settle down a little bit. Next man saying, look, he's got to give me some room so that do something with the ball, I get it. So Singapore, let's see if catch and shoot. Let's see what they got in mind. Circling around is Desmond O. Over the head. Oh, back up jumper, no good. Howard with the rebound. Kicks it back outside again. So a fresh 14 for Singapore. Long three is going to be off the mark. Back outside right in the hands of Fong. He'll hold it up and look for Elliott. Lamb. Elliott to his left. Tyler Lamb with three fouls. Goes around the back screen. Bounce pass to Fong. Fong outside to Elliott. Elliott left side. Brings it for three. There goes your four-point lead. One-point lead now. Great job by Lamb to find Elliott on that left-hand side. Alexander, still Alexander. The shot's gonna be off the mark. Rebound again by Fong. The opposite side. Finding Chan. Elliott again, 1 point lead at the 8 minute mark for Singapore. Swings it. Long three for Elliott. On fire, Marcus Elliott. Playing with four fouls, but there is no tomorrow. If you're the Slingers, you've got to put a hand in his face. 2 point lead now for Hong Kong. Elliott with 22. My goodness, last 5 points. There it is, the rotation. But you're not gonna stay with me, okay. So the Tyler Lamb and Marcus Elliott show for Hong Kong here in the fourth quarter, timeout by Singapore. They'll have to remedy that. So as we suspected, Michael, you know, at this point in the game, okay, he's got 4 points, but no point putting his offensive powers on the bench at this point.
Hey, looking at the defense of the Singapore Slingers, right, I think they should really relook at running a zone at a long line. It seems like Elliott has been able to find his groove from the outside. So they should look at going back into the man-to-man.
Slingers applying that zone. Has been fairly effective if you look at the scoreline, 61-59. Now, remember, Hong Kong averaging 91 points during the regular season. Singapore held them to 76 in their loss last game. Held them to 79 in that first game, which the Slingers won 92-79, and Hong Kong coming back to their scoring norm in game two, scoring 92 points. But it really hasn't made that much difference because Hong Kong has also played great defense. So two teams that are really showing their strengths, and Hong Kong a little bit extra on defense. They were only the fourth best defensive team in the regular season, but you wouldn't know it by watching them in these finals. Alexander momentarily had Wong open. Going around the screen, Alexander putting the ball on the floor, rising, firing, no good. Rebound by Boone. Boone getting the ball off to Fong. Fong to who else? Elliott. He'll walk it up. Turning into a half-court game for both these teams. Turnovers at a premium. Elliott, bounce pass inside, tipped up in the air. Good job by Alexander. They were trying to get that entry pass into Boone. So 4 seconds on the shot clock. Singapore would dearly love to get a stop here, come back and score, put a new wrinkle in this game. Elliott still going at it, verbally at least with Elliott. Elliott and Alexander going at each other. Referees. Alexander is asking, hey, tell him to stop leaning on me, ref. Alexander with the essential motor mouth, he talks throughout the game, and the referee telling Elliott, yeah, I'm seeing what you're doing. So finally, Lamb. Inside it goes, off the mark. 24 second violation, that shot does not catch iron, so a turnover. Singapore doing their job on defense. Delvin Goh will inbound it. Here comes Wong and company. Downstairs to Alexander, now to Howard. Desmond O will cross over the baseline. Screened by Howard, skip pass over to Goh. Goh looking for Wong, nine on the shot clock. Goh accelerates in the lane, jump stop, back outside. Desmond O for three, no good. Alexander bringing down the rebound, stepping in his land, but he touched it last. It'll be Singapore ball. 6:48 to go. Still a two-point game. Again, if Singapore should win this game, game five would be in Hong Kong. That would be on Tuesday. If Hong Kong wins, they lift the trophy right here on Singapore's home court. Desmond Wong. He'll take the long three and be way off the mark at that time. Wow, ill-advised shot that time by Wong, way long. Elliott, patient as always, will set up the half-court offense for Hong Kong. Singapore, again, looks like a 1-2-2 defense. Playing the point. Lamb over in the corner. Long three is going to be off the mark right in the hands of Desmond O. So two air balls for both these teams. Alexander trying to pick up the pace a little bit. Offensive foul on Alexander. That'll be two on him. Lane waste to the Hong Kong player. Let's see who that is. Watch him going right at him. Now that will be on Howard, actually. So first team foul in the fourth quarter by the Slingers. Back in the game comes Josh Erzbintanto. You see Hong Kong Bin also in the game for the Slingers. Elliott will rev up the motor here on the offense for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. League champions and trying to do the double here in the ABL championship. Josh Boone steps up. Little jump step there by Lee. Long three is going to be off the mark. Tipped out again. Alexander gets to it first. Singapore three on two. Spin move. Howard. Yep. Tie game. Great job by Alexander to find Howard. Howard does the rest. 5:35. Elliott to Lamb. Inside. Back outside. Lamb working on Alexander this time. They'll try and find Elliott on the opposite side. He's lurking out. Ah. Separation from Lamb. Wow. That's a two. Tyler Lamb. Him and Elliott, it's their show here in the fourth quarter. They retain the lead. Circling up is Erzbintanto. Howard. Boone on him. What do we have here? Offensive foul. My goodness. Bodies hitting the deck. We held our collective breath. Let's watch it again. Push, I guess, they're saying on Alexander. So Alexander with two. So break here for Hong Kong. They have the two-point lead and the ball. We get down into crunch time. I don't know. We saw questionable calls in game two, a couple here on both teams, which, to be fair. Hong Kong has some cases to be made, too. I'm thinking of that foul on Fong a little bit earlier. Elliott playing with the four fouls. Tyler, off-balance shot there. Boom! With the follow, can't get it. In the lane again, picked up by Singapore. Alexander with the ball. Long lead pass. Skip pass inside, knocked away by Fong. Horrible turnover there for Singapore. Under 4:30 to play. Elliott again, patient. Boom, down low. Good ball movement by Hong Kong. Back outside to Elliott. Five on the shot clock. Erzbintanto chasing. Three. Lamb. Still Lamb. Can't get it to fall. Last touch by Hong Kong, and Howard saves it. Lead pass. Wide open. Look for Desmond. 0 for three. No good. Follow, no good. Alexander getting the ball back. He'll kick it back outside. Erzbintanto for three. Yes! Singapore by one. Josh Erzbintanto. Crowd on their feet here at the OCBC Center. Beseeching the team for a stop. Elliott. Takes the long three, drains it. 2-point lead now. Cool as a cucumber, Josh Elliott. Well, putting the exclamation part, Michael, on why he was the MVP of the league. My goodness.
Oh,
huge shot in a huge situation. The old adage, the best teams have their best, or best players have their best games against the best teams. And Elliott epitomizing that at the moment. Alexander swinging it to Josh. Howard fighting for position. Downstairs and a foul, and that will go on Lamb, and that will be four on him. So four on Lamb, four on Elliott. Watch it again. Reaching over the top. Weak side help coming over, and by function. So Alexander, a chance to tie it up here at the line for 3:07 mark. He's been excellent at the free throw line so far, has Alexander. One aspect of this game, as we've said before, that has risen in this 2016-2017 season. So this one to tie it up, 13 of 18 from the line. Just to knot it up. Off the mark, rebound by Boone. So Boone gets it over to Elliott. Underneath the 3-minute mark, Hong Kong spreads it out. Boone navigating down on the low post again, flashing across is Fong. 3 on the shot clock. Fong, laid back. Jumper is good. Wow. Clutch shooting by Hong Kong down crunch time. Irvin Tondo now popping up his Downstairs again to Alexander. Alexander, Fong working on him. Howard short with that shot. Fong with the rebound. Now in control of the game, at least for the moment. Long pass downstairs to Boone. Elliott. Tenser let the clock roll down on their offensive possession. Elliott again stutter step. Lamb for three. Off the mark. Desmond O with the rebound. That would have been a backbreaker had that gone in. Irvin Tondo now. Alexander looking for Cutter. Offensive foul.
Wow.
Alexander being called for the foul. That's 3 on him. Let's watch it again. Well, I think that's the correct call.
You know, with the intensity of the game for so long, they call it a tic-tac foul.
Yes, yeah, that's true.
You know,
you don't want the game going away from the players. Yes. Is the thing, and that's what Michael's talking about. You want the players to decide the game, not the referees.
Definitely.
So 3-point game, and Singapore in desperation of a stop right here. Elliott. They spread it out again. It has success with this formula. Ong Bin Han accelerating to the basket. Turns, shoots, way off the mark. Stepping in, getting the rebound. Irvin Tondo, Alexander, still Alexander, back outside again. Irvin Tondo for 3. Got it! We're tied at 68. Got Irvin Tondo. How do you like that? 1:15 to go. Singapore needing a stop. Crowd chanting out defense. Perhaps 1 minute left in their season. Do they have it with them to send the series to Hong Kong? Long three off the mark. Elliott wanted it to be his shot. Wasn't able to make it. Irvin Tondo. Important for Singapore to stay in control here. Ung Bin Han on the right side. Bounce pass inside. Irvin Tondo thinks better of it. Comes back out. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Fong. Singapore will have the ball with 6 to go on the shot clock. 38.5. Two excellent defensive teams going at it. Timeout called by Hong Kong. They will talk it over. When we come back, Singapore, 6 seconds, Michael Wong. try and get it going, try and get a bucket and go back and get a stop and then wind this thing down. So it is coming down to what we thought of. Two excellently coached teams, two very determined teams, two excellent defensive teams who, never mind Hong Kong's ability to put a lot of points on the board, they're trying to win it with a half-court game. Singapore probably feels more comfortable in that sort of position, but Hong Kong has been right there with them the entire time.
Two evenly matched teams, I must say. You know, they've really showcased the whole, with both ends of the court, defensively, offensively, they made it all, playing at a very high level. And it all boils down to this 38 seconds.
What about Josh Wong getting two huge shots just when they needed him? We sort of denigrated his shot selection a little bit earlier on. Of course, he had that unfortunate foul in crunch time last game, but he's doing everything he can to make up for it now. Who knows, he may be called on again. Or will it be Boone on the other side? Or will it be Elliott? It's just so many players, so many actors in this stage right here. It's just impossible to tell how it is going to end up. There is Erzman Tondo right there. 16 points for the little man who was brought over to Singapore when none of the other guard imports really worked out for them. And he has brought that veteran presence. He's 34 years of age, veteran of the PBA, and not afraid to sling the ball up, that's for sure. Six on the shot clock. Alexander, long on him, turns the corner, and he's fouled. So for Fong, that is four. Quick move by Alexander, and there's the push. Boone coming over, trying to supply the weak side help. So 35.5, that play took about 2.5 seconds to develop. It gives Singapore a fresh 14. Getting it in to Erzman Tondo underneath the basket. Back outside, Alexander will reset. There's a screen. Alexander, the backup jumper, is going to be off the mark. Ball right in the path of Lamb. So 20 seconds. It all gets down to this. Elliott with the ball. Will it go overtime or will Hong Kong lift the trophy right here, right now at the OCBC Center? Here comes the screen. Elliott. Misses the shot. Boom. Off the mark. Shot. No good. We're going to overtime. Four kick to the can for Hong Kong. They can't put it in. Boone is furious. And a fresh 5 minutes for these two teams that will not say die. A very disappointed Coach Torres and players for Hong Kong. They had the ball on the lip of the basket and could not finish. Look at it again. Boom right there, first attempt. Now Lamb throwing it up, in and out. A follow by Boone, no good. Another angle. Saved by Howard momentarily, but off the body. And you can see how close that was, Michael. In and out, my goodness. So close and so far for Hong Kong.
Oh, this was going to dodge a bullet.
Now, looking at the foul situation, getting back to that, Elliott with four. We've got Lamb with four. We got Fong with four. So, on the other side of the ball, Quet with four for Singapore. Also, Alexander with three. Erzman Tondo with four. So, both teams have their woes as far as foul trouble goes, but I would think advantage Singapore in those situations just because the quality of their players who are in foul trouble. I mean, without Elliott, they are not the same team, that is for sure. And Tyler Lamb, don't take anything away from him either. Both those guys have been golden from the perimeter down the stretch. When they need the baskets, those guys almost took turns piling on, putting one end and then the other. So that has kept Hong Kong, Eastern Long Lions in the game.
Yeah, I totally agree with you on this point, because if you look at the foul trouble on Long Lions team, Lam has four, Elliott has four, which means there's no one who's able to match up with Alexandra at the moment. And right now, the good thing is, they should try to get Alexandra into the low post, because it seems like he's not getting a handful.
So Singapore looking at the rebounds, a big edge, 51-37, 17 O boards compared to 9 for Hong Kong. However, Singapore 24-69, a poor 35%. Hong Kong not much better, 26-66 for 39. The turnovers, Hong Kong with 9, Singapore with 13. So the hand tipping a little bit in the favor of Hong Kong in that quarter, but Singapore doing just enough, as we said, to force it into overtime. So a fresh 5 minutes on the clock. And some tired players out on the court. They just played a mammoth game 2 nights ago, and they've got to come up and wind it up again should this game go to Hong Kong. And Singapore obviously trying to do everything in their power, along with the fans here, to make sure that there is one more game in the reservoir for both these teams. And if that happens, one would think that that's the way it should be. Erz Bentano, remember, playing with 4 fouls, being dogged by Elliott. Howard downstairs and out of the hands of Alexander. So first turnover game, number 14 now for Singapore. You just joined a 68 apiece at the end of regulation. Elliott leading the way for Hong Kong with 23. Howard coming alive in that fourth quarter. He's got 16. Does Alexander. Elliott, bounce pass inside to Lamb, rises, fires, got it. Tyler Lamb getting position on the inside. Plays much bigger than his 6'5", or 6'4", frame. Erz Bentano gets one screen, Lamb switches off on him. Alexander, shot clock down to 7 in the lane, rises, fires, gonna be, oh, he got the shooter's roll. 70 apiece now. You take him any way you can get him at this point in the game. Elliott again. Patient as always. He's got Boone upstairs. Now Boone rotates down, as is Lamb. Lamb has that mismatch with Erz Bentano. Let's see if they work that again. Goes to the left hand, fires away on a 3. No good. Howard stepped in the lane, got the rebound. Singapore with the ball. Alexander with 3:46. Still Alexander. Erz Bentano thought about it. Screen there. Rises and fires. He's going to be short with that, stepping in the lane, but knocking away is Fong. Made a mistake in not grabbing with 2 hands. He pays the price. Singapore will still have possession of the ball. Coach Ngo, ballistic over there, as one would expect. So 14 on the shot clock. Alexander circling over to the top. Ben Hahn in the game too. Alexander around the screen to fire it up. In and out. Fong with another board. Back comes number 8 checking in the game. Chan Siu Wing again, but he quickly gives the ball to Elliott. And again, they spread out the offense, Michael. Now it coalesces with Lamb. He'll switch over to the right side, left side. In fact, Ben Hahn on him now. Lamb, little show and go move that time. And what do we have here? Do we count that? No indication yet if that should count or not.
No, I don't think it. No. It's going to be baseline. Base out of bounds.
So it'll be Hong Kong ball out of bounds with 14 left on the shot clock. Some wary warriors out there. Tyler Lamb walking over to the near sidelines to check it in. Elliott. Singapore trying their best to neutralize him, but that's a tall order. Elliott still bounce pass inside to Boone, yes! 72-70, well, we haven't heard from Boone in a while. Nice little break that time, getting in between both Alexander and Howard to slice up the middle. Get the bucket, Alexander. Erz Bentano. Alexander, he'll like that matchup there. Let's see if he works it. Boone lurking around, supply the double team. Erz Bentano head down inside the lane, has the ball blocked. Ball in the hands of Hong Kong, finally corralled by Marcus Elliott. The 2:17. Hong Kong, opportunity to take a 4 or 5 point lead right here. They'll take their time, 10 on the shot clock. Here comes the switch. Now 5 seconds. Ball knocked away. 1 second. That goes, does it count? No, it does not. So a turnover. Elliot just a little bit too lackadaisical with the ball that time, Michael.
He looked a little bit gassed. I see him stretching it, his legs out a little bit. I mean, he's been doing a lot for the whole entire game. So you might wonder, you know, how much has he left in his tank?
Desmond Oh checking back into the game. Singapore trying to employ some fresh legs as Wong Wei Long. So three guards, three true guards for Singapore. First in Tondo. Slices across. Bump and grind time for Alexander, who gets the ball downstairs to Howard for two. Tied up again. Both these teams in half court mode. Usman Tondo, Tyler. And there's a foul by Usman Tondo, and if that is on him, that will be five. So Usman Tondo will check out. 16 points to his ledger. He'll get a nice hand by the crowd, and Tyler Lamb just a little bit too quick for Josh. So Delvin Goh will check back into the game for Singapore at the 1:32 mark. First overtime. And at the line, Tyler Lamb. Calmly salts that away with the Singapore Slinger Nation down his throat. Hong Kong has had the lead the majority of the game. Singapore did have a 6-point lead briefly midway through the second quarter, but has usually been Hong Kong up by 2, 3, 4, as many as 7 points until Singapore had that marvelous 9-2 run to come back. Yes! 2-point game, a minute and a half to go. So Singapore will need a bucket here and then come back and get a stop. Alexander, let's see if they play the two-man game with Howard and Alexander. Again, Howard at the high post. Ung Bin Han will shuffle over. Now he cuts through. Alexander. Still Alexander, stops, pops, got it. Xavier Alexander, 20 points. Revving up the pace a little bit comes Elliott. Now he gives it off to Fong, back outside to Lamb. Fong to overload down the right side, up pops, boom, boom, 10 seconds on the shot clock. Elliott looking for some separation. Shot is up, it is off. Stepping in the lane is Ung Bin Han. Now back comes Singapore. Alexander forcing the issue. Travel. Well, the X-Man trying to do a little bit too much. Shades of what we saw yesterday. I think you're no doubt or watch it again. He does see a little sliver of a space and trying to go through, and the fans thinking they saw a foul on Boone, but not to be. So 46.1, a fresh 24 for Hong Kong, tied at 74. Elliott and Lamb and company. Look for Elliott or Lamb to work off of the screen, or if not, pass to Boone downstairs. Alexander and Elliott will do battle. 40 seconds. 12 on the shot clock. There's Boone up for the screen. Acceleration by Elliott. Back outside. Fong. Shot could be way off the mark. Controlled by Alexander. Back in the hands of Wong. Singapore can play for the last shot. Alexander will hold it up. Singapore's turn to be patient. See if they can get the ball downstairs and at the very least get a foul. Five on the shot clock. Alexander stopping, firing away, going to be off the mark. And that will do it. 74-74. We're going to the second overtime. My goodness. Wow. Well, Coach Yeo can be excused for thinking that is a opportunity that went by the wayside. I think that they should have played for a little bit better shot than that. I don't know. Maybe play off of Howard downstairs. Look at this. And Howard, instead of going downstairs, reverse direction. So I think Alexander saw that out of the corner of his eye and felt that he had no choice but to take that shot from a very, very difficult angle, Michael.
I mean, for last possession, I think Singapore should have at least come up with something better than that. I mean, this is a challenge rush shot. They should give themselves a better chance to win the game.
So to Hong Kong's credit, they've got Elliott with four fouls. They've got Lamb with four fouls. They got Fung with four fouls. And none of those guys relented. What they did do to change tactics a little bit is they're just not quite as aggressive on the offensive end. Spreading out the defense, walking the ball up and looking for the open shot, using Boone as a screen, and then rotating him downstairs and trying to get the open look. And for the most part, it's worked for them. Singapore, Earth Ventano fouling out of the game, so we won't be seeing in his last second heroics anymore. It's going to have to be up to one of the other guys. Ung Bin Hong getting a lot of PT these last couple of stanzas. But at the end of the day, you have to feel it's going to be Xavier Alexander or Justin Howard or maybe Wong Wei Long for Singapore that's going to have to bring it home for the Slingers. On the other side of the ball, who else but the MVP, Marcus Elliott, or perhaps Tyler Lamb, unless they can free up Boone downstairs. So Singapore hanging on for dear life, desperately trying to get this to go to a fifth game in Hong Kong. That'll be on Tuesday. It'll be on Arena Sports. That'll be in Hong Kong. There he is, right there. The MVP of the ABL for 2016-17, Marcus Elliott. His Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions with the ball right now. Number eight, Chan Sui Wing. Working on him is Wong. Tyler Lamb inside. Bong. Yeah, boom. Foul and one. Very well drawn up by Hong Kong, rotating the ball. Lamb did the dribble penetration. And that left Boone isolated. With Delvin go, and that was his first foul. Can't hit the free throw. Nothing strange about that. So first overtime stats amended, 22-70, 27-76, Singapore shooting 36%, 28-71, 39% for Hong Kong. Singapore owning the rebounding lead. Oh yes, Delvin go, head down, up, swirling it home. And you could see that time, Michael, Elliott did not want to commit himself and pick up that fifth foul.
Kudos to Delvin, going strong to the basket.
Tyler working on Hong, loses in, the ball up in the air. Foul on Ung. So Ung Bin Hong, believe that will be five fouls on him. And if it is, that will be it. Watch it, there it is. So Ung out of the game. So two Slingers, first Earth Ventano, and now Ung Bin Hong getting a nice applause. 2 points on the afternoon for him, and at the line, good free throw shooter. Number 12, Fong Xin Yi, and Singapore try as they will, just cannot break on top of this very resilient Hong Kong Easter team. They've got a lot of weapons off the bench and on the floor. Their local guys are some of the best we've seen in the league. Calmly knocking down the first one there. An excellent free throw shooting team. They have averaged 80% coming into this game. And they've certainly not put up any untoward stats to change that. One of two right there. So 1 point lead at the 4 minute mark. Alexander threading his way through two defenders. Coming back out again. Wong barking out signals. Howard will shift down to the low post. Ball knocked away momentarily. Walked away again. Lucky to keep possession, and they kick it away, and that was a kick on Singapore, so Hong Kong will get the ball back. And an unfortunate turnover for Singapore. Quick hands of Singapore once again, and Fong right in the middle of it, Michael. So Fong Xin Yi showing that he's more than just a jump shooter, getting involved with the offense. Remember, he's playing with four fouls as well. So putting it all on the line for his team. Back comes Chan. Chan with the left hand. There's the screen. Using the screen to roll to perfection. Lamb losing one man off balance. Fong with 10 on the shot clock. Goes to the left hand. rises and fires off the mark. Game rebounded by Singapore. Fleck sticks his hand there to get it. 1 point lead, Alexander. Wide open look for Justin Howard. The tip, no good. Back to the hands of Howard. No, Fleck's got it now. Back to Howard underneath. Yes. Singapore with a 1 point lead. It's a 3-12 mark. Lucky he didn't call for 3 seconds there, Michael.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking about.
He was in there for an eternity.
Yeah.
Elliott rises, fires, got it in one. Every time they need a bucket, they get it from Elliott. My goodness. So at the line for a free throw to make it a 2 point game. Just when you think Singapore is going to break out, up pops Elliott or Lamb, one of the two. 3 minute mark. And I don't think the crowd will have any effect on this guy right here. Ice water in his veins. Some of the Hong Kong fans there going, that's right. 2 point game. Wong. Still Wong threading his way through a couple of defenders and back outside to Alexander. 11 on the shot clock. Wong trying to go baseline. Not there for him. 5 on the shot clock now. He's going to have to be creative. Dumps it off to Howard. Howard with the shot. In and out. Back the other way. 2-on-1 break to Tyler. Yeah! Hong Kong by 4. Singapore forced to call a timeout. And what do we say? The Elliott and Tyler Lamb show, Michael. No denying it.
The two of them has been carrying the whole load for the Hong Kong Long Lions. You know, they score at right when they need it. You know, either Lamb or Allen, who's going to hit the big shot right after the Singapore Singers get some advantage. And if you look at the last shot by Howard, he has no lift on his shot at all. I really don't know whether he's fatigued or is he really nursing an injury.
Well, Elliott with 26 points. He got Tyler Lamb with 21. Really, that has been the story of this game. 4 point margin now for the Hong Kong Eastern Line. Now they can go back to their slowdown game if they want to. Singapore in a position now, even if there, you know, there is 3 minutes left in the game, or 2:28 left in the game, but Singapore in a position now because of the slowdown approach of Hong Kong. They need to score every time down the court, and they've got to have stops.
The Long Island Alliance are actually deploying a 3-2 zone again. So they're trying to force the Singapore Singers to take some shots from the outside, and because they know Alexander doesn't really hit the three-pointer. Now with Howard, if it's, I don't know what's wrong with him right now, but he doesn't seem like he's hitting his mid-range shot as well. So you know now they're able to pack the paint, get the rebound, you know, and slow it down again, and get some time off the clock.
Singapore, as the rule has come even, or even knows themselves a point or two ahead, just to get, it just seems to spur Hong Kong on. Alexander, Howard, circling around is Wong and almost losing the ball. Desmond O gets some separation. In the lane he goes, bounce pass over to Howard. Back outside, Quet now. Quet has the ball knocked away. 5 on the shot clock, so Singapore again with this possession, living dangerously. And they just sort of seem out of ideas, Michael. You're right, there's something wrong with Justin. He just does not seem to be, his energy level, or whatever you want to call it, just does not seem to be up to what we're used to seeing him. Of course, that could have something to do with playing two games in the last 36 hours or so.
I think the Singapore Singers are very used to having him in the low block and running through some offense off him and getting really some points from him at the down low block. So right now, they're a little bit out of sorts.
Howard and Alexander, both with 20 points. And you see Fong working on Alexander. There's a shot. Got it right in. Yes. 2 out of 2, so 82 to 80. Leon Quet coming through. So back comes Elliott. Singapore needing a stop here. Elliott in the lane. Back outside it comes. 8 on the shot clock. Fong catch and shoot. Off the mark. Ball batted back to Elliott. Nice play by Boone. Fresh 14, now 138. down to 6 on the shot clock. Elliott working on Alexander, accelerating in the lane, up, off the mark. Rebound Justin Howard. Now then, Singapore chance to tie it up. Wong Wei Long. Round one defender inside the lane, backs it up. Howard, no good. Rebound by Quet. Back out it comes to Wong. 110 on the shot, or on the game clock. Wong, Quet, Alexander. Alexander forcing it, kick back outside right to the hands of Hong Kong. Now Hong Kong with 57, a chance to put the game out of reach. They'll take their time. Elliott playing the fourth foul. He's got Boone up top. Howard will follow him. Lamb going at it. There's a mismatch down with Desmond Oh. Let's see if Elliott will use it. Long three. No good. Ball controlled by Hong Kong. 32 seconds. Lamb around Wong. One-handed leaner. No good. Hong Kong again. Oh, the kick. The kick. The ball kicked by Hong Kong. Singapore will get the ball with 23.3. Fong, you can see his leg come up. So Singapore stays alive. What hustle on the floor by Hong Kong, though, Michael.
Yeah, Fong.
Loose ball after loose ball, getting to it first.
Yeah, Fong seems like he wants it more than anybody else on the court.
So Alexander will inbound it.
Yeah, Singapore Singers really got to make sure they run a very good play, because during 3 seconds, you know, they're going to run down the clock to probably 10 seconds. They'll get a shot up and give them a chance. If they missed it, they're going to foul immediately.
Into Wong. Wong will be trapped. He gets around that. He chased by Chan. Alexander will hold it. 13 seconds to go. Howard. Rotation. 9 seconds to go. Alexander, wide open look. He will take that. And he will miss that. The ball goes out of bounds. Let's see a foul. Let's see who that's going to be on. Going to be on Boone. So 3.7 to go. Singapore will get another kick at the can. Let's look at the shot. Leaning over. Whoa. Boy, that's a tough call, isn't it? 3.7 seconds for Singapore to do something. Inside. Rising, firing. Way off the mark. The game will be over. Hong Kong are your champions. Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions will win the championship of the ABL for the 2016-2017 season. They did it on the back of their MVP, Marcus Elliott, with a big, big assist from Tyler Lamb, Fong Xin Yi, and everybody else on the team. What an effort. Singapore Slingers just a little bit short in double overtime. Cannot get the quality shot they needed at the buzzer, and they will go down to defeat 3-1 on their own home court. So back-to-back trips to the finals by the Slinger, but no cigar. It'll be another season of disappointment for the Slingers, and Justin Howard, who knows, he may have just played his last game for the Slingers, Michael.
Yeah, he really looked like he's hampered today. Yeah. With his age at 36, I mean, you really want to wonder, are the Singapore Slingers going to keep him for next season, or are they going to develop new blood?
Well, obviously, Howard not playing at full strength for this Game 5, but Coach Torres, to his credit, you know, you play the guys you've got, and you play against the team that's out there against you, and Torres did a magnificent job rotating his players in. What about Marcus Elliott, Tyler Lamb playing with 4 fouls for a whole quarter and 2 periods of overtime without going out of the game? I mean, that is unheard of. They stayed out of foul. They stayed away from any more fouls. They ran the offense. They ran their picks up top, their pick and roll, vaunted pick and roll. They worked it to perfection, got the open looks, and knocked down the shots when they had to.
I thought Elliott really controlled the tempo of the game very, very well at the last two OTs. You know, it was really his, the Elliott show. And then when people come and help on him, he drops it down to them, and who scores?
So Singapore Slingers made a good game of it. The fans have nothing to be ashamed of. The team has nothing to be ashamed of, but still a heartbreaking loss for the Slingers. They finish the year 3-1 down in the finals. They desperately wanted this game to go to Hong Kong. If they're going to lose, at least lose on, you know, your opponent's court. You always hate to let your opponents win on your own home court. But hats off to the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. They led the league. They won the league with a 16-4 record. They've got the most valuable player on the team and on their side. And Josh Boone also with a huge impact. Of course, don't forget Stephen Guinchard. He wasn't that much of a factor today, but play of the day, that is Josh Boone getting ahead of the offense on the outlet and going down and dunking it in transition. Let's watch it again. One step and just pounding it home, tomahawk style. Another look at it from a different angle. And at the end of the day, they needed every point they had. So here are the stats. Singapore, 30 of 85, 35%. The other side of the ball, Hong Kong, 31 of 79, 39, marginally better. Look at the rebounds, 62 to 43. Singapore out-rebounds Hong Kong by 19. 16 turnovers for Singapore. Again, a little bit too many turnovers. Hong Kong taking care of the ball very well. Only 10. The assist of no consequence. The steals, Singapore had 7-3. But I think you can look at the turnovers again, and you hate to be a broken record, but Singapore in those last three games, they just didn't take care of the ball as good as Hong Kong did, and they were made to pay the price.
I mean, look at the stats, right? It's really quite even, Steven. That's why the score is so close. I guess it really boils down to the players. You know, who you got on the team, who wants it more? And I think Hong Kong Long Lions, they want it a little bit more.
So the presentation of the trophies will be coming up, and there it is. The COO of the ABL presenting it to a very, very happy Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions team. That will be a beautiful thing on the flight home, the Cathay Pacific flight home. And they will no doubt have that on board with them. It's not going in the cargo hold, I'll tell you that. Very happy bunch, and they thoroughly deserve this game. They lost the first game by 16 points, were basically blown off the court in their own gym, and they came back and took a very ill-tempered second game, ill-tempered in the sense that there were objects being thrown on the floor, questionable referees' decisions, but they stood tall and came away with the 8-point lead. And then Michael did the hardest thing you can do as an opponent. Come on your opponent's home court and sweep them away. They did it in style on Friday night, and they did it again here the tough way in double overtime, escaping with the 82-80 victory. And Marcus Elliott just being named the MVP player of the finals, and he certainly deserves it. Tyler Lamb, I would say, would be a close second. But the hats off to the Slingers, and especially their imports, Xavier Alexander, Justin Howard. They may never wear red and white again, but what a ride it's been for them. They have willed the Singapore Slingers into the finals for two seasons in a row. And if they're not that next year, they will be sorely missed.
Yeah, good news to the Singapore Slingers. They really fought their heart out. You know, they got to take their hat off to the Hong Kong Lions. I mean, they really executed. They played very well. But the Singapore Slingers, taking nothing from them, you know, they played their heart out. They deserve this stage. I mean, they deserve a chance.
There is Fong and number 8 Chan Sui Wing, and where would Hong Kong be without them? They needed quality minutes from the bench, and these two guys stepped up. Also, don't forget Lee Key. So we've got an interview down on the floor with Elliot Dankar and company. Elliot, what you got for us, buddy?
The Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions take it by just 2 points. I'm hanging out with the finals MVP, Marcus Elliott. Very emotional at the end. In fact, Coach Torres said something to you. What did he say?
What, right there?
Yeah, right there.
Oh,
right,
man, he just told me there's no way he can express the amount of respect that he has for me. And I told him likewise. You know, this championship started back in the summer. I didn't know if I was going to have a job after leaving Argentina and winning a championship last year. And Coach Torres actually is the one who got me over here. And man, all glory to God. First and foremost, before anything, all glory, honor, and praise to God, man.
Beautiful story. Hey, how hard is it to play in, you know, a foreign land? I mean, this isn't your home ground. You've won 2 games here. How hard was it?
Man, the Slingers are a tough bunch anyway. Xavier is a tough motherfucker, excuse my English. But I got the utmost respect for the Singapore Slingers. Howard, everybody, you know what I mean, their bench, their local players, their coaching staff. This arena is a tough place to play. The fans are good for them. Man, whew, all glory to God, man. I don't even know what to say.
You were awarded the World Import MVP. You're also the Finals MVP. Favorite game the entire season?
My favorite game the entire
Your
season?
Favorite game?
I would have to say game two at our house when I got ejected.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
And our team did it, you know what I mean? It doesn't matter about me. It's a five-man game. You know, they didn't tuck their tail in nothing. They stepped their game up. They secured the win, and that gave us the momentum coming into here.
Nicely done. Well, from one Elliot to another, congratulations, and enjoy the party tonight, my friend.
Thank you, brother. Ain't no party. We're getting some rest, man.
It's back to you, Chuck.
Well, thank you very much, Elliot. And there, another scene of the very, very happy. Oh, they got individual trophies, too. That's a nice touch. Every player gets a miniature trophy of the ABL trophy 2016-2017, but there's a pop-up trophy right there. And again, congratulations not only to Marcus Elliott and the rest of the team, but to the ABL for staging such a wonderful season this year. As we've said, Michael, many, many times, that the quality of this league just keeps getting better and better with every year. And we look forward to 2017, 2018, and they're right around the corner. They'll be loading that up. We'll have the Merlion Cup, no doubt, in September. And with that, for Michael Wong and all the production staff here, Chuck Schreiner, again, the final score, the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions 82, the Singapore Singers 80. The Long Lions are the champions for 2016-2017 of the ABL. We'll see you next time.